the Colts. The Colts living or dying, quite frankly, is going to be decided this weekend. They died a little last week. Not killed, but died. A little bit. Thanks, Mike. Lose this one, pretty much dead. Then you have to make a decision, right? I know you play for pride. I know it's the NFL. I know we're all men. I know blah, 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 blah. But at the end of the day, you're dead if you lose this one. So what do? You go that pride nonsense, or do you play for a draft choice? Because let's be honest, a year from now, you want the Colts to be really good. The locals will say that this is a rebuild. I don't think anybody inside the organization looks at it as a rebuild, certainly not the players, but it may be. The next few weeks is going to decide whether or not this is a true rebuild. Because if you lose this game, and just for the sake of argument, just for the sake, the Ravens win the game, you're done. It's over. You're not coming back three games down. Ravens have a better schedule, so away you go. And there's other teams involved, and you won't jump them. So then if this is really a rebuild, then what you'll see the Colts do is you'll see the Colts lose games. Because the idea is, all right, playoff, rebuild, we got to get a better draft choice, lose more games, get a better draft choice. That simple. I mean, but it's complicated because you have human beings involved, but that's basically the importance of this game. Now, those of you that say, hey, look, I don't want the Colts to make the playoffs. What's a big deal? Go play, pick a team and get beat. Nah, that's crap. The most important thing that you can have in your program, I say this all the time, whether it's NFL, NBA, college, whatever, is momentum. Postseason play breeds momentum, period. It does. Sitting on your backside watching others breeds draft choices. It breeds doubt. It gives you a goal for the next year, don't get me wrong, but it breeds doubt. And I've gotten a lot of this from people. Well, what's the use of making the play? You keep talking about the playoffs. I said this about the Pacers a couple years ago. I'll say this about every single sports team. The number one thing you have in your program is momentum. Bob Knight did not get fired for choking a kid or grabbing a kid. Bob Knight got fired because he gave him the opportunity to fire him because he did not have momentum in his program. Everybody around that program knew and felt that the momentum was gone. Gene Katie did not get fired because he's a bad coach. They didn't have momentum and they needed a fresh start. Just the way the world works. And making the playoffs with this particular team would give the Colts unbelievable momentum. What does momentum mean? I don't know. You say to me, well, Philadelphia didn't get momentum. That's a different deal. When you win a championship, you saw it earlier with Villanova, and I was going back and forth with Jay Wright the other day, and Jay's like, look, we need humility. You can get humility in college basketball in the first couple weeks of the season. You can lose by 100 to Michigan. You got a lot of time left. You can't get humility, or you can't afford humility in the NFL, get your brains beat out early and think you're making a move. I mean, the statistics on guys and teams making the playoffs just being 0-2 is staggering. So, momentum, Uncle Mo, and I want our show to do better. So by having a better show, we're better if the Colts are better. It's just the way it is. I digress, but that is, it's always going to be a little self-serving. No, has to be a little bit. Anyway, but that's the big deal tonight. Orlando, 12-13. On the road for the Pacers, game you kind of got to win. Now, I don't, do you guys follow this? Like now, every time you open up anything ESPN, I'll use ESPN, it may be CBS, it may be whatever, and you look at a matchup, it says matchup predictors, 59.6%. That's what the Pacers are in terms of predicting to win tonight. As a two-point favorite, Pacer two-point dogs tonight. Do you guys ever look at that? I would be curious. I would be very curious if the Pacers or any team, what the record is of that predictor. Because I look at this and I say exactly what this predictor is. This predictor should be in the Pacers' favor, because I think the Pacers are a better team, and the NBA home court this time of year doesn't really matter. You know what I mean? It really doesn't. Like, Paul George yesterday going off for 47 or 2 days ago, like, who cares? It's a game in December. It's the 40th game of the year. Do that in the playoffs, and now we'll have a conversation about greatness. I think, anyway. Victor Oladipo not going to play. This is old team. You know what I'm saying? All that kind of happy horse bleep. That's not great. But one of the things that I think has been interesting with this is how the Pacers have played without Victor Oladipo. And I'm not necessarily talking about wins and loses. They have been fairly inconsistent with or without Victor Oladipo. But one of the things Victor Oladipo, last year, as we know, they went 0-7 with him. One of the things that we know about Victor Oladipo is I thought they never looked comfortable last year without Victor Oladipo. Now they do, which I think is very cool. Now, people say, well, you got to learn to play without Victor Oladipo. Let me ask you a question. Why? Why do you have to learn to play games without Victor Oladipo? Like, there isn't a coach alive, he may say that to, I don't know, you or me or anybody else, but he's not saying that to his team, that, hey, look, it's really important that we learn to play without Vic. Why? I mean, you want to play well without Vic when Vic is out, but there's no, absolutely no. You want to develop your team. You want to develop the guys, the best guys on your team. You want to develop their chemistry. You want to develop their esprit de corps. You want to develop them as a unit, and you want to go through ups and downs. How about that? I mean, ups and downs would be awesome. Ups and downs as a group is great. Like, people don't know how to handle failure, right? People don't know how to handle, hey, man, we really struggled. I'd say this all the time. I do. I say this all the time. The best teams are the ones that struggle, come out of it, and they come out of it for the better. The best families struggle. You come out of it, you come out of it for the better. The best people. You know, what's that old deal? Abraham Lincoln lost every election. I remember thinking Ronald Reagan, like, this guy's running for president again. It felt like when I was 10 years old, I saw the name Ronald Reagan. When I was 12, I saw the name Ronald Reagan. 14, and he was always losing. I mean, he's always getting his ass beat. Next thing you know, he wins. He's a president. You're like, holy hell, this same guy? I mean, everybody. You look at great coaches, and this is when you're a young coach or you're in your first year. This gives you inspiration. I'm telling you, you look at Belichick, failed, didn't he? I mean, did Belichick fail? Of course he failed. Now, people say, well, he took him to the playoffs. No, when you get fired, you failed, at least in the eyes of the public. I don't think in the eyes of most people. But a lot of people fail. Like, you know, it's a little bit different now because you're not really given time to fail. You know what I mean? Like, you're not – 3 years, Mike Krzyzewski, you all know. Tom Landry, the greatest football coach in Dallas Cowboy history. Let me give you his first years. 0-11, 4-9, 5-8, 4-10, 5-8, 7-7. Can you imagine Tom Landry in this day and age starting out 0-11 and 1, my bad, 4-9-1, 5-8-1, 4-10-0, 5-8-1, 7-7, and then he was off to the races. NFL championship game, NFL championship game, playoff, lost in the Super Bowl, won the Super Bowl. NFL championship game, NFL championship game, lost in the Super Bowl, lost in the playoffs. Champions, NFL champions, lost in the Super Bowl. I mean, honest to God. I mean, you can go through, but we don't allow ourselves to fail anymore. Failure is good. Failure is good for the soul. It is. Failure makes you strong. I'm telling you right now. People always bitch, whine, and moan at me about, well, you played for Bobby Knight. Yeah, it made me strong. Well, you suck. You got divorced. You got fired. Yeah, it made me way strong. Telling you. We don't let people fail anymore. You don't like your team in AAU, you transfer. I don't mind kids transferring college. You don't like your team in AAU, I don't like it. You don't make the varsity, you transfer. No, stop that. Again, I don't have any problem with people transferring. Hell, two Heisman Trophy winners in a row are going to transfer. I'm just saying, failure ain't bad for you people. And failure is not bad for your basketball team, your football team, whatever. It's just a matter of how you're going to come out of it. Are you going to quit? Like, I watched last night, And I know they got hyped up for one game, but Jacksonville Jaguars, my ass. Did you see the play where Jalen Ramsey late in the game gets a tackle behind the line of scrimmage, and he flexes like they just won the Super Bowl? And I think it was Tyler Lewin came up to him, and he flopped like a fish. I mean, that's all you need to know about that team. When's the last time you saw championship teams do that? When is the last time you saw a championship team or a championship player act that way? You know what I mean? You going to listen to that guy? What's he want? Talking about Bob Knight momentum. Bob Knight momentum. Put him on the air. All right, what do you got here, champ? What do you got? What you got?
Is Dan?
Yeah.
Hey, Dan, I just wanted to say I don't have your acumen. I don't know IU basketball like you do, but when Bob Knight got fired, he was gaining momentum. He was gaining momentum.
He was?
A.J. Moye, Dane Fife, and they went to the championship game.
But they just lost in the first round of the tournament to Pepperdine by 20, and there was a massive CNN report on him.
I understand, but you got to understand, CNN, who gives a damn about CNN?
Well, apparently a lot of people watched it. Huh?
Idiots care about CNN.
So wait a second. Who do the smart people care about?
I think smart people can think for themselves, and they don't have to watch the brainwashing media. I mean, they can differentiate
what's
bad. And then you got to understand, and that's all I'm saying. I mean, time tells the truth. And Bob Knight's players, I mean, A.J. Moya was one heck of a guard. And, I mean, like I said, I don't have your basketball acumen. But he was the guard that IU had been – and Bob Knight had been missing for a long time. And Dane Fife was the floor general. And 2 years later, I mean, I was excited. I mean, I was excited, and I was disappointed to see Bob Knight. And I think Bob Knight lost his – I think when he lost his job, it was mainly because of politics. I mean, I can't stand the kind of people that have to have power and have to be in charge.
All right, I don't care what you can stand and what you can't, but let's be honest with you here. All right. I mean, if we're going to be really honest about you here, and I'm a Bob Knight defender for the most part, but I'm also a very realistic person. If I'm the athletic director and I watch my team play the way that team played, and I watched the years leading up to that where kids are transferring, CNN, or you can say, let's just take the news organization out of it, but kids are transferring all over the place. You go 9-9, 9-7, 9-7, 10-6 in the league, haven't competed for the Big Ten title since 93. That's 8 years. I mean, haven't been out of the first round. Actually, haven't been to the second weekend in 6 years. I mean, you lose. I'm sorry. You can think whatever you want, but that's a loss of momentum. Period. It just is. It is.
I understand.
I don't think
your
you do.
Argument.
I don't. It's not an argument. What I gave you is just straight facts. And
I get it.
Yeah. I don't think you do, because you're going to. Because what happens in these instances is and I can tell by your voice, you're from Southern Indiana.
I'm not.
People.
I'm actually from up north.
Okay.
You're from.
Oh, good. People don't want to listen. When people have opinions on things, the facts don't matter. People say, hey, look, I understand, I get it, but, and it's like, I'm just giving you the facts, and I know. I mean, I know from inside that Bob Knight
I agree with you. But, I agree with you on your position, but I'm just telling you.
I know,
you,
but I'm
more,
just telling
there's
you.
There's more
all
right. to it.
Really?
More to it.
What's more to it?
There's more to it.
What is it? What's more?
Recruiting class.
Oh, stop. Oh, just stop.
AJ Moye, he had great players.
Okay.
He was going to win a championship again.
I know. I know he was.
I mean, hey, you didn't win a championship, but I knew it was coming.
Yeah, I did. I won one in 97.
I know, but I was 87. I was there, too, but you were the player. You were a coach then.
Yeah, that's part of it. I mean, I got a ring. Is that bad?
But no, you're good. We love you, Dan. We love you.
There's no we. You don't.
You
don't speak for.
You
don't speak for.
You
don't speak for anybody. Come on. I mean, if you don't think Bob Knight didn't lose momentum, I can't help you. I mean, I'm sorry, but I can't help you.
Momentum. I agree with you. You made a great point.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm saying. If Bob Knight hadn't lost momentum, if Bob Knight was coming off of a 32-5 year, I don't care if he choked Neil Reed, and I don't care if he grabbed that fraud-ass kid. I don't care who that, whatever that kid's name was, Shaw. I don't care if he did that. They would not have fired him. But he had.
Politicians always have their argument.
And you're not listening. But I don't care about you. Just telling me goodbye. Get out of here. But I'm just telling you, if Bob Knight didn't lose momentum, he wouldn't have been fired. AJ Moyer. That's fine. AJ's a nice player, nice kid, going through hard times. Hey Dan, if the entire show is full of Bob Knight truthers, what does truther mean? That's like that thing you guys made up about Trump. Is that like birther? What's like it used to be in Indiana, Bob, what did Kravitz and those clowns call it? Bob Knight apologists, or you're drinking the Kool-Aid. Like everybody in Indiana, here's the way Indiana used to go. Indiana was this when the media, it was really the first social justice warriors, right? The message boards and Kravy and all the clowns here in the local media that disliked Bob Knight. It was always this. If you did not want Bob Knight as your coach, then you get it. Like, you get it. He gets it. See, he really gets it. I had people tell me, man, you really get it. When I would say something that doesn't really pertain, it wasn't flattering about Bob Knight. If you didn't want Bob Knight as your coach, Kravitz, these, because Kravitz was like the columnist in 2000, right? I know he came in 2000, but Benner, whatever the hell his name is, Robin Miller, all these guys, well, you get it. Now, I've never at practice, never around, never did anything. Talk to Kitch is what they used to say. But the truth of the matter is, then if you defended Coach Knight, like if you had firsthand information and you defended Coach Knight, then you were drinking the Kool-Aid. That's exactly how it went. Like you could probably get articles or whatever from these clowns that say, oh, he's a Kool-Aid drinker. I didn't drink Kool-Aid. I just tell you the truth. But again, it's the precursor to social media and social justice media guys now. If you don't agree with the stance of the masses, all right, then you are dismissed as a Kool-Aid drinker. By somebody, the masses, that never were involved there. And that's what's frustrating to me ultimately when you discuss Coach Knight and the people around here. It's literally like when somebody, I've said this before on the show, when somebody says, oh man, he gets it. That implies the person saying that has an understanding at a level that most of us can't. And that he's the judge of that. And that's just silly. That's just silly. I don't even defend Coach Knight. I'll be the first to rip Coach Knight. But I'm not going to sit here and tell you that he had momentum going. He didn't even, Coach Knight at the end wasn't even smart enough to play Tommy Coverdale. I mean, not like all of a sudden Tommy Coverdale became Tommy Coverdale. Tommy Coverdale was Tommy Coverdale when he went to Indiana. I mean, momentum is, how do I feel about Mike Davis taking him to the Final Four? I loved it. I thought it was awesome. It was a great day for me. I got the West Virginia job the day they beat Oklahoma. Turned down the UAB job. Took the West Virginia job. I mean, I'm just saying. We're going to have David Bell from Warren Central, the Football Player of the Year, come on at 2:30. We're going to talk to him. We're going to get a little more local with this show. We're going to get more local guys that do locally good things. There you go. Anyway, 317-239-1070 is the number. Dan at 1070thefan.com is the email address. Andy Katz coming up. We're going to talk about crazy night in Iowa City, and you know I like crazy.
Hey guys, good news. The outrageously expensive Little Blue Pill is now generic, which means you can get the prescription medication to treat ED at affordable prices. And Hims makes it extra affordable. Right now, get your first month's supply for free. All you pay is just $5 for your medical consultation when you go to 4hems.com/perform. After that, it's just $30 for a month's supply. Sure beats paying big bucks for just one blue pill, doesn't it? Plus, you won't need an awkward in-person doctor's appointment to get the prescription. Hims has doctors online who can prescribe the medication, and a pharmacy sends it right to your door. It's affordable, private, and incredibly easy. Nobody likes dealing with ED. Now, thanks to Hims, nobody has to. And that's really good news. To get your first order for just $5, you need to go to this exclusive address, 4hims.com/perform. That's 4hims.com/perform for your first month for just $5. 4hims.com/perform.
Best service, best products.
Hi, Pat Sullivan here of Sullivan Hardware and Garden. Yes, we have thousands of home improvement items in stock, but what separates us are the things that you won't find in a typical big box store, like the largest selection of pre-lit Christmas trees in Indy. You can actually see 150 different styles of artificial Christmas trees or enjoy your Weber grill all year long. And don't forget the world's best smoker and grill, the Big Green Egg, available at Sullivan Hardware and Garden.
Your neighborhood Do-It-Best is stocked with items to fill his toolbox with great gifts like your choice Stanley Tools, Wonder Bar, 50-pack utility knife blades, utility knife, tape measure, or rip hammer, only $4.97 each, or a Black & Decker 29-piece screwdriver bit set, only $7.97. Projects are endless with a Dremel rotary toolkit, only $69.97.
Shop local, shop Do-It-Best. Visit Sullivan Hardware & Garden, 71st and Keystone, 49th and Penn, and in Cicero.
Hey, Michael Grady here for the good folks over at Payless Liquors in the 26 locations around Central Indiana. And we're in December, the holiday season. You can stop in to get some great deals right now. Crown Royal Indiana Glassware Gift Sets, $22.99 while supplies last. Smirnoff Holiday Ornaments, $9.99 while supplies last. Jack Daniels, 1.75 liters, Black Label, just $39.99. And their next bourbon event is coming up December 12th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Adams Street Carmel location. Why pay more, get more, and pay less at Payless Liquors.
Think the Salvation Army is just a red kettle at Christmas? Ask Carrie, who recently received the help she needed.
Saw the ringing bells, never knew about the shelters or any of this until I got into the situation I got into. So when I walked in, I was expecting to see, you know, bunk beds out in the middle of the floor and things of that nature, and it blew me away. A totally different experience.
To make your donation, call 1-800-SAL-ARMY. That's 1-800-SAL-ARMY. When you make your donation to the Salvation Army, expect change.
This holiday, dare to show how much you care. From now until December 9th, for every $500 you spend on merchandise at Jared, you'll earn $200 in Jared rewards toward your next jewelry purchase. Just shop online or find a store near you at jared.com. And dare to be devoted.
Exclusions and restrictions apply. Visit jared.com/rewards for full details. Purchase price excluding tax must equal at least 3 times the amount of your Jared rewards redeemed. The certificate will be reduced in $100 increments based on the purchase price. Cannot be combined with other offers or trade-ins.
Indeed knows finding the right hire takes time away from your business.
Hiring a qualified data engineer felt like a second job.
More job seekers use Indeed than any other site, so there's no better place to find someone with the skills you're looking for.
I needed someone with a master's in computer science and database experience.
Plus, Indeed screener questions help you find your shortlist fast.
Now I'm back to having just one job.
See why more than 3 million companies worldwide use Indeed to hire. Post your job at Indeed.com/hire. Indeed, the world's number one job site. Source.com score total visits.
Hey, Dan Dockett here for Hubler Chevrolet. Go to drivehublerchevy.com, hang out, and learn. That's right, learn. Here's what you learn. You learn where the best deals in the state of Indiana are, and you see the biggest selection of Chevys in the entire state of Indiana. Drivehublerchevy.com, place to go.
Looking for Colts tickets? Join JMB every Friday at a bar near you for Bud Light Blue Friday. Come meet JMB, and it's your chance to win Colts tickets each and every week.
Think you know Colts football?
57 yards.
But do you really know what's happening?
It's not just football season.
It's Venturi season.
This is Rick Venturi. I'll be breaking down the Colts play all season long on The Fan, presented by the District Tap, located on 82nd Street, just east of Keystone Crossing. 60 beers on tap and damn good food.
Catch the coach with JMV Mondays, Wednesdays with Dan Tokich, and Grady and Big Joe on Fridays. Presented each week by the District Tap.
Dan Tokich, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Nobody covers college hoops like Andy Katz. You've known him for a long time. Coming from the land of enchantment in Albuquerque, through Tark and the boys at Fresno State, ESPN, now Big Ten Network, Fox, radio, TV. You know Andy Katz. Hey, last night, a little crazy. You called the game in Iowa City, Iowa State. Me likey, a little crazy at the end.
Well, you like that. It was very physical.
Love it.
And that's what you want out of a rivalry game. And, you know, there were no punches thrown, but it got a little chippy. And you want a little edge in a game like that. You know, the first half scuffle, or however you want to phrase it, Connor Pemsel, who I thought gave great effort and energy in his first game since the first game of the season for Iowa, came in a little late into the scuffle. And then at the end of the game, you know, we get into these whole things of debating about the handshake and how much they are important. Should you have them? And it had been a very frustrating night for Iowa State. And so they never even got to the handshake because you saw Jacobson kind of punch at the ball. And Connor McCaffrey didn't like that. And then, you know, basically there was a lot of back and forth. And Prohm went on the court to try to separate everyone. And then after both coaches in the postgame, at least, you know, admitted that emotions got the best of them and they moved forward. And I talked to both of them after for a while and they were all fine. There was no ill will and they have a good relationship. And it was just, you know, heat of the moment.
You know, it's funny. I thought Fran McCaffrey was in an absolute no-win situation, right? I mean, like, he's known as a hothead. So if he stays out there and something happens, people bitch about, well, you got to get him off the court. Why is your team still on the court? And then if he takes him off, well, you're not sportsmanlike. You got no handshake. I thought watching it on TV and just my initial thought, I thought, man, I didn't think Steve Prohm did a whole lot to defuse the situation. I thought, like, man, you're running out there like a crazy person. But why was Iowa State punching at the ball? You know, we see it so many times, Andy, where, you know, the game's over, let's go. And they were still guarding, kind of trying to hack around a little bit when Bohannon made the layup. Why didn't Iowa State just say, all right, you know, you're giving up, we'll give up?
You're right. And I actually was thinking that exact same thing in those final seconds because – the game was over, and I thought, and you know when you call a game, you're going to say, oh, they're going to call off the dogs.
Yeah.
And Prohm looked like he was saying that to, like, not to foul, but the players weren't. The players were still in, you know, right in the defensive stance, and they were trying to guard, and they were upright on the Iowa players. And so you could see that they weren't going to quit until that final buzzer. And then at the end, I blame Iowa State because they were, you know, in terms of initiating this, because McCaffrey's just holding the ball. The game's over.
Right.
It was Bohannon, I think, was just holding the ball, and it's over. And so to just sort of swipe at it just escalates it, and it was unnecessary. And I'm glad at least after there was nothing. You know, sometimes these things carry over.
Absolutely.
You know, down the hallway and all
right.
That didn't happen on either side. And, you know, I talked to Steve outside after the game, and he was fine. And same with Fran. They were all good. So that's good. I'm glad at least it all stayed in the confines of the arena.
You know, the because in Iowa City, you go out the same exit, right? I mean, there's a little divider there, and the home team goes a little bit to the right to their locker room, but you're going through the same tunnel. And, you know, like in Indiana, you go one way, people go the other way. Purdue, everybody goes through the same tunnel, that kind of thing. That's not always great. You're right. That's not always great. That could have been a problem in that tunnel back. Because those ushers are old, man. I love them, and they're nice, but they're old as hell.
They've been there forever. and I'll tell you, I don't know what it is about the Big Ten.
Yes.
I went to school in the Big Ten. I love the Big Ten. But I'll tell you, all the ushers in the Big Ten, they are old.
Hey, Andy, they're hanging on to those jobs like grim death, man. They ain't letting them go, bro.
And you're right. It seems like it's in every arena.
It is.
But I'll tell you this. I think you agree with me on this. I think the Big Ten will be the best league in the country this season. It wasn't last season. But I really believe that and that last night was a very important game for Iowa, more than Iowa State, because Iowa State's missing two of their best players, arguably their best player, Lindell Wigginton, still not healthy, and Solomon Young was out. I think 11 teams will feel like they have a chance in February. Now, 11 aren't going to make it, but I think 11 will feel like they have a chance. And I'm including Northwestern in there because they probably are the best 0-2 Big Ten team we've seen in a while. I mean, they were a bucket away from beating Indiana on the road and beating Michigan at home, which would have been two monster wins to start the season. They're clearly better. I don't know if they'll make it, but I think 11 will feel like they have a chance, you know, maybe in early February, and then we'll see how it all plays out.
I heard you say that last night, and I'm using that, and I'm not footnoting you. Because I think you're absolutely right. I do. I think you're 100%. When you said it that way, like they'll feel like they have a chance, I think you are 1,000% right. And let's be honest, Iowa, who's sitting here, you know, 0-2 in the Big Ten as well, had to go to Michigan State. That was a monster win. And I think it was a monster win for the league, right? Because you can't just win a few games in the ACC Big Ten, you know, tournament and say, oh, well, we're a great conference. I mean, you got to win some games. I thought that was a huge win for the league last night. I did.
Oh, I think a great win for the league. And because, right, even look at Iowa. I mean, they beat UConn and Oregon in New York, and I don't think UConn's a tournament team, and Oregon has been really inconsistent. I don't know if they will be. And the thing with people say, oh, you know, how can that many teams come from the Big Ten? Well, look at the rest of the country. The Pac-12 is down. You know, the Big East is not what it was last season. They're not going to get as many. The A-10 may only be a one-bid league. The Mountain West may only be a one-bid league. The West Coast Conference may only be one big league. And, you know, the American – that may only be a few bids. We'll see what happens there. So there will be other bids to pull from, and I think the Big Ten, the ACC, you know, and probably – I say those two will get the most, and then after that, in some order, the Big 12 and the SEC. So there will be other places to pull bids from for the Big Ten to get its share, but it won't be a gift. They will earn it because, I mean, the depth right this season is certainly there.
Yeah, no, I agree. Hey, let me ask you this. I'm going to preface this by telling you I absolutely love it because I think college basketball, Cal Perry wants to play college basketball in August, and when you listen to him, it's not that stupid of an idea. But if you're not going to play Indiana and Kentucky and you're not going to have all these rivalries on home sites, I thought the Big Ten this particular week was absolutely fantastic. What did you think?
Love it. And I think a lot of this has to do with the fact that these teams get together, to your point, so early.
Right. Now.
And so when they're in, you know, in summer, July and August, and they're working out, they're taking these trips every 4 years and playing exhibition games. By the time they get to November, they're pretty good. I mean, it used to be, as you know, you start October 15th, and that's the first day you started. And so there's no way you'd be ready the first week of November. And so now, by the time they get to November, they're ready to go. And the Big Ten was forced to do it last season because of the week early with the tournament. Now, this is going to be the new normal. The first weekend in December around the championship game when students are still in session, that's key. There's a couple years ago,
yes,
when the Big Ten played a couple games around New Year's. I say you do it this weekend that we just had. And the ACC, when they go to 20 next year, is going to have to do the same thing and will do the same thing, you know, putting it that same weekend. You want to do it when the students are there. And, you know, I think, like, that Michigan-Northwestern game the other night,
yeah,
that was one of the best games of the year, a high-level game in, you know, what was it, November, whatever it was,
whatever.
Early December, late November.
Yeah.
So, you know, I think it's great for the game. It's great for the conference. And I think you're going to see more high-level leagues do it.
Yeah, and, you know, here's a funny thing. You know, in Indiana, I was considered a national holiday, October 15th. In high school, that's when you start. In college, that's when you start. People still think that that's when you start. Like, how could a team – I got a lot of this last week when it was, you know, people realized, wait a second, Indiana's playing Northwestern to open the Big Ten season? You know, how could they do that? Practice starts October 15th. I'm glad you made that point because you practice – essentially, you practice year-round. I mean, there's breaks in there, don't get me wrong. But essentially, you're practicing year-round. That's not October 15th. We got to play December 1st. No, that it's totally different now. I got to ask you about a couple teams, Andy. Seth and I were talking, and I felt something strange about North Carolina when they got split by Michigan. I felt them coming apart. I didn't think they were overly talented because the bigs haven't gone well. What do you think of Carolina, and what do you think of Syracuse? Because the converse, I saw them play really well.
Okay, on Carolina, you know, Coby White, I saw him when I was in Vegas, and, you know, he's sensational, but it's weird how they've shifted so much responsibility to him, or at least he's taken it. And that's great on one side because he's electrifying, he can score, and he's fun to watch, but it also meant that the ball didn't really move much.
Right.
And then I started to think, and maybe this isn't fair, but as good as, you know, to have sort of veteran players, Luke May, Cam Johnson, Kenny Williams, you know, it gets to the theory of, okay, so you've got older guys, you've got seniors, veteran guys, but they've never been 1, 2, 3. They've always been sort of 4, 5, 6 and not had to move up, you know, into that first slot. And how you handle that, because not everyone can, you know, that's a huge jump a lot of times. And, you know, I remember last weekend, Miles Powell from Seton Hall, I was talking to him about this because last year Seton Hall was a veteran team and, you know, he was the fourth option. And now he's the first option. And he told me, and I think this happens to a lot of players, he said, I had to learn, you know, how to be much more selective with my shot because now I'm the one that had to take most of them. And that's not a comfortable position for a lot of people. And so I think with Carolina, their older guys, you know, aren't as good as their previous older guys. And I think that's showing. Nasir Little, you know, maybe he'll be great, but he's not great yet. And I think there was a high expectation with him. With Syracuse, you know, I think we got to judge them going forward from that Ohio State game. With Frank Howard, because they didn't have him earlier in the season. So I think now sort of is a reset in judging Syracuse. And, you know, I think they definitely will be one of the four best teams in the ACC.
Hey, last thing before I let you go, Andy Katz, Four Winds Lakeside, In-Am Arena Hotline. All these freshmen, where does Romeo Langford fit in with, you know, the freshman class this year? Where is he in it?
Oh, I think he's one of the best. And in a way, I think now, you know, it's hyper-local within the state of Indiana, but nationally, he's been allowed to sort of perform without that huge spotlight on him that obviously is shining all over Duke. And so he's having quietly, I say quietly nationally, probably not in Indiana, but quietly nationally, he's having a great start to his season and putting up numbers. But I don't feel like he's, you know, under that microscope constantly because we're sort of Zion all the time.
Yeah, he'd be a green room guy, though, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
That's what I'm saying. We are Zion. You know the deal. We are Zion the time on, baby. You know? Hey, tell my boy Timmy O'Shea I said hello, will you please?
I will.
Thanks, my friend. Thanks for the time. Appreciate you. Great job last night, by the way. Really enjoyed the broadcast. Oh, my pleasure.
Thank you.
That's Andy Katz, Four Winds Lakeside, In-Am Arena Hotline. Andy Katz has been covering basketball, and he has been doing a great job. You can go to The Andy Katz with a K, A-N-D-Y-K-A-T-Z, The Andy Katz. David Bell, maybe the biggest winner in the state of Indiana from Warren Central, is going to join us at 2:30. Doug Kazarian coming up at 1:30. If you'd like to call us, 317-239-1070. Am I wrong? Did Bob Knight have momentum in his program? I didn't think we had any momentum left in Indiana when he got fired. And that's why he got fired. Stop with all the other stuff.
There are times in life when certain situations are unavoidable. As life passes, we get a little slower and a little more achy than the year before. All part of life. But when we lose the ability for intimacy with the one we love, it can feel much worse. Unfortunately, the lady we love typically feels like this situation is just because of her. As men, we know that's just not true. We want that spark back just as much as she does. The Indianapolis Men's Clinic physicians hear this from struggling couples every day. Fortunately, that struggle in your relationship from erectile dysfunction can be gone. One simple visit to the Indianapolis Men's Clinic with a same-day solution. The joy of your relationship will be back. And the best part of it is seeing that spark back in a happy relationship. Call 999-9000. It's simple, safe, and private. 999-9000. Clinic visit, evaluation, and testing is just $99. IndyMensClinic.com for more information. 999-9000.
Hey, this is Jeff Saturday for More Restoration, and you've heard me talk about More Restoration for years. I've used More Restoration 3 times on my home. I care about my family, and More made me feel confident in using them. Speaking of confident, they have a new service. It's a hospital-quality disinfectant that is safe for your home, and it's endorsed by the EPA. Within a few hours, More Restoration can disinfect your entire home. Best of all, nothing needs moved, and it's safe for all your belongings. This service makes it safe to come home. Call More Restoration Disaster Cleanup and tell them Jeff Saturday sent you.
At Huntington, we're always looking out for you. So when our customers told us it can be tough to keep track of spending, we invented the Spending Drone.
How can I help you today?
Oh, I'm looking for a dress to wear tonight.
Budget on track.
Is that your drone?
Oh, yeah. That's my Huntington spending drone. Follows me around. Make sure I don't overspend when I go shopping.
Amazing. Well, these are the dresses over here. Anything else I can get you?
Yeah, maybe some shoes to go with it.
Over budget.
Or how about some earrings?
Over budget.
How about a necklace?
Nope.
Scarf?
Nope.
Belt?
Mm-mm.
Lipstick?
Sorry, over budget.
How about just the dress?
Budget on track.
That thing follows you everywhere?
Yep.
That's, helpful.
So we simplified. Presenting Huntington Heads Up. You set the monthly amounts you want to spend on shopping, and we'll send a heads up to your phone to keep you on track. It's just one more way we're looking out for you. Huntington. Welcome. Member FDIC, carriers, message, and data rates may apply.
Hey, what better gift to give yourself this holiday season than the gift of vision? Dan Dockett here. I've been telling you about my life-changing LASIK experience with 2020 Institute. It's safe. It's painless, and it worked, most importantly. 2020 Institute is a local company with a highly experienced local surgeon, Dr. Zay. Get in for your complimentary consultation. Have your procedure before December 31st for $700 off and a $100 Visa gift card. Book right now at 2020indy.com. That's 2020indy.com. In fact, I was talking to former IU legend or current IU legend, Jimmy Cruz, about it this morning. I think he's going to do it.
35 degrees, 10 degrees, 4 below. Three reasons why you need a reliable furnace this winter. Hi, I'm Corey Kreitzberger, General Manager at 1 Hour Heating and Air Conditioning. Call 1 Hour today and we'll set you up with a reliable new furnace for about the same price per day as a fancy cup of coffee. Call us now at 855-1-HOUR.
Your comfort is just a call away. Call 1-HOUR.
Terms and conditions may apply. License 800-1-0668.
Hey, Dad. I wanted to remind you that the holidays are close. Real close. And Mom and I don't need wool socks again. At Helzberg, you can get jewelry from Mom and get a free Nintendo Switch system for me. Two gifts in one trip. I'm not saying you're a last-minute shopper, but I'm not saying that either.
Get gifts that get gifts at Helzberg Diamonds, like a free Nintendo Switch system when you spend $1,199 or more. Helzberg Diamonds, a Berkshire Hathaway company. Limited time offer while supplies last. See online or in-store for details. Game sold separately.
Hey, JMV, join me later on today at 3. Old Pros Table, Broad Ripple, Bud Light Blue Friday, Colts Cowboys tickets. Tony D will be there, and I have all your questions answered at 3.
Welcome to the Colts Midday Update on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan. Here's Matt Taylor with today's report.
Welcome to the Colts Midday Update on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan, presented today by Shelby Materials. The Colts take on the Texans on Sunday for the second time this season. The Texans won the first meeting 37-34 in overtime back in Week 4, and since then they haven't lost. A big reason for their success is J.J. Watt, and he and Andrew Luck are in the running for the NFL Comeback Player of the Year Award. We'll hear from Houston head coach Bill O'Brien on that in 30 seconds.
All right, you have the perfect contractor for your project. Now it's time to get your concrete company. Have they called Shelby Materials? We stand behind our work and products. Why? Because it's the right thing to do. We only do quality concrete and aggregates. And we work with an experienced staff that cares. Need a stadium, parking lot, highway, or driveway? Remember, when you're ready to pour, Shelby has your back. We know concrete and aggregates. Learn what you need to know. Shelby Materials.
Completions, percentage, passing yards, and touchdowns. J.J. Watt, the three-time Defensive Player of the Year in the NFL, essentially broke his leg last year in Week 5, and so far this season, 11.5 sacks and 20 quarterback hits. Both players are in the running for NFL's Comeback Player of the Year, and Texans head coach Bill O'Brien says both guys are deserving.
The level of respect that I have for both players, it's hard to put into words. You know, obviously I'm very fortunate. I've been able to be around J.J. For 5 years now. Great football player, great person, and works very, very hard. He's been through a lot from an injury standpoint and has worked very hard to get back to where he's at. You know, he's done a fantastic job. We've competed against Andrew Luck for years now. Andrew Luck is he's the ultimate competitor, very tough individual. I'm sure, you know, I know Andrew, but, you know, I don't know him real well, but I can tell that, you know, sitting out was probably not his favorite thing. You know, I'm sure it was killing him to have to miss those games. And so, you know, he's come back. He's a great football player, and he presents, a huge challenge to us.
And the Colts look to end the Texans' 9-game winning streak on Sunday and stay alive in the AFC wild card race with a win. And that's it for the Colts Midday Update, presented by Shelby Materials today on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Dan Dockage, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
You know, Kyle and I are just looking up there. The question is, now there it is right there, Kyle. Can the Bears win this game after, should the Bears start Mitchell Trubisky against the Rams? How dumb are people? Like, you just lost to the Giants. You just lost to the Giants. Now, as you said, I'm sure, Kyle said it, I'm sure the argument is, well, you're going to lose anyway. How stupid is that? And Aaron Donald's going to kill you. How stupid is that? Name me one. I know there's professional athletes that listen to this show while they drive around, and I know a lot of coaches do. But name me one. Just name me one person that ever thinks like that. Like Venturi was talking this morning, and it's so right. Like the NFL, you die week to week. Bears have 8 wins. That doesn't mean they're going to get 9. Like you, if he's your starting quarterback and he's your guy, there is zero question. It's not like he got Wally pipped. It's not like all of a sudden Chase Daniel came in and won these games. He won one game at Detroit and he got his ass beat the other night, put 27 up, but who cares? If he's your guy, hey, look, you got the Rams, you got the Packers, you got at and at. There's no guarantee you're getting into play. If he's your guy, you better get your guy in the game. It's so ridiculous. And a lot of you listen to that. A lot of you listen to that nonsense. A lot of you say, ooh, these guys are so smart. We got to listen to these guys. That's unbelievable to me. People. If you want to sound like somebody that's played or coached, don't ever say stupid stuff like that. Because nobody that's ever played or nobody that's ever coached thinks like that. You think like, damn, we got to get our team together. We got to get going here. We got to have our best player going. We got to win games. And if he's our best, then you got to go with him. Oh, man. Sometimes it just drives you nuts how, like, how can that even be in anybody's thought? I get it can be in somebody's thought that's doing a show because they want people that aren't very bright to watch. But how could that be, like, anybody? If they came to me and said that, we're going to talk. I'm like, I'm not doing that. Ish kabibble. We're going to talk to Doug Kazarian at the bottom of next hour. We're going to talk about gambling this weekend, who you like, who you don't like. I'll tell you what I like last night. I like Purdue basketball. I don't love their team. I don't think they have anything inside, and I don't like the fact, I don't think they're very quick. But I liked them last night on the defensive end, man. They made switches. Maryland had no answer in the last 3 minutes. And I'll be honest with you, a lot of people in Maryland bitch, whine, and moan about the coach, and they have no offense. And maybe that's true. I haven't really studied them yet. But having said that, Maryland to me ran a great out of bounds play under the basket with a lot of different options, and Purdue communicated and got it done. No shot. Didn't even get a shot. Got a shot that got blocked. Didn't even get 10 feet off the shooter's hand from 20 feet. It's a great defensive effort by Purdue. Really good. I mean, really good. And Aaron Wheeler has come on. Aaron Wheeler, to me, look, all right, listen to me. I'm not saying he's Kevin Durant, okay? But he jumps up and shoots it like Durant. He's long like Durant. He is not Kevin Durant. But when I watch his game, it reminds me of a dirt poor Kevin Durant. Dirt poor. Not a poor man's. Dirt poor. But when he lifts up and shoots it, he kind of has the same legs. He kind of has the same look. And he's long and he's athletic. I don't know if he's athletic, but he's long. And he seems to be very comfortable on the perimeter. I watched yesterday. I said, damn, that's Kevin Durant-like. Oh, he's pretty good. And that's what – look, people always say we play these games to learn something about our team, right? Well, Purdue learned that they can sit down and defend. We always know that Mackey is going to be very loud, very volatile, and they're learning that Aaron Wheeler can play. Aaron Wheeler got his chance because he did not sulk. He came in the game against Michigan when their team was getting crushed and played his backside off. And that's what everybody should do. That used to be the Indiana way. Now, Indiana coaches over the last couple of years, I haven't seen them really reward guys like that. Doesn't mean they won't. I just haven't seen it. Oh, yeah, that's me. I got my angler's jacket because I'm an angler. Like, I used to love the fact that you knew if you didn't play much, Coach Knight, if you came in practice, started lighting it up, he was going to give you a chance. And he also, the other way wasn't great either. If you played well in a game and you didn't come out, at least me, Alford could do Alford things because he was better. Whitman could do Whitman things. But I love that. Like, people don't do that anymore, but I love the fact that Matt Painter gave this kid a shot because, quite frankly, this kid wasn't playing a whole lot. The game was over. He came in and looked very, very confident. This is, I asked a question earlier about the predictor on ESPN. This is from Nathan. Dan is a hardcore gambler. I can tell you the ESPN prediction percentage will bankrupt you. Let me tell you something, Nathan. I will never look at it again. Nope. No. You know what I bet on? I bet on coaches and culture. And I hate to say this, but last night there was no way, and talent, and there was no way Purdue, no way Purdue was going to cover the 8.5 last night. That's a lot. I'm going to be talking about gambling for a lot of the day. We're going to talk at the bottom of the hour with Doug Kazarian. If you would like to give me your thoughts on the Pacers, now is the time to do it when we come back. 317-239-1070, or you can email me, Dan, at 1070 The Fan. We'd like you to subscribe to YouTube. We are go to YouTube.com and type in 1070 The Fan. We are live on YouTube, and we're going to be live on YouTube every day. I think John's live on YouTube. I think Joe and Mike are live on YouTube, and I'll answer questions on YouTube if you would like. But again, go to YouTube.com, and subscribe.
The Ride with JMP.
And I know that everybody's supposed to be happy. I mean, what did I pick them at the start of the season? 7-9. Oh, well, hold on a minute. They are who we thought they were. And that might be the case, but they were in position. Certainly, you're going to have to win out. And win out starts coming up on Sunday in Houston. But I was completely disappointed.
The Ride with JMP. Weekdays from 3 till 6 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Do you have a love-hate relationship with your credit card? You love the freedom and convenience the credit card gives you, but you hate the high interest rates? And let's face it, they're high. 17, 18, even 20% APR? That's pretty outrageous. But with Lightstream's credit card consolidation loan, rather than throwing your money away on high interest payments, you can get a much lower rate, as low as 6.14% APR with AutoPay. And today, if you want an even lower rate, apply at lightstream.com/radio for a special discount. Plus, with Lightstream, your rate is fixed, so as rates continue to rise, your rates won't budge. They'll stay low. You can get a loan from $5,000 to $100,000, which means you can pay off your credit card and start paying an interest rate you can really love, thanks to Lightstream.
Ready to start saving? Apply now at lightstream.com/radio. That's right. Get your extra discount by applying today at lightstream.com/radio. That's lightstream.com/radio.
Subject to credit approval. Rate includes 0.5% auto pay discount. Terms and conditions apply, and offers are subject to change without notice. Visit lightstream.com/radio for more information.
Hi, this is Matt Taylor, radio voice of the Indianapolis Colts. We are proud to partner with the Indiana Blood Center to help raise awareness of the importance of blood donation and do our part to help boost the blood supply and give back to our community. Every 2 seconds, someone needs blood. That person could be a friend, family member, neighbor, or even you. In order to maintain a safe and healthy blood supply for patients in hospitals across the state, Indiana Blood Center needs to see 550 donors every single day. Unfortunately, when the weather gets cooler, donations usually decrease, even though the need does not. That's why the Colts are once again partnering with the Indiana Blood Center to encourage our fans to raise their sleeves and give the gift of life to those in need. I encourage you to make an appointment to donate blood at your nearest donor center or mobile blood drive. To schedule your appointment, visit versity.org/IndianaBlood. That's versity.org/IndianaBlood. On behalf of the entire Indianapolis Colts organization, I thank you for saving lives in our communities.
Chad and Tyler Peterman for Peterman Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing.
Before Old Man Winter arrives, there's still time to call Peterman for our $59 preseason furnace tune-up.
It's a great way to make sure your home stays comfortable in cold weather.
And at just $59, our furnace tune-up is a smart investment for your peace of mind.
But don't delay. Winter will be here sooner than you think.
Schedule your $59 preseason tune-up today.
Call 859-4270. Peterman's the way to go.
Indeed knows it's hard to find qualified candidates when you're hiring.
It's like finding a unicorn.
But when you post your job on Indeed, it's easy to find people with the skills you need.
Nurse practitioner, 4+ years experience, acute care certification.
Indeed has a huge pool of amazing candidates and screener tools that help you find your most qualified applicants.
Whoa, an entire shortlist of unicorns.
See why more than 3 million companies worldwide use Indeed to hire. Post your job at Indeed.com/hire. Indeed, the world's number one job site. Source.com score total visits.
Hey, it's Daniel J. Dockage here. Daniel J. Dockage for Hubler Chevrolet. Listen up, because Hubler is changing how you buy a vehicle. This is unbelievable. Introducing the 10-year, 200,000-mile limited warranty on all new Chevys. 10 years, 200,000-mile limited warranty on all new Chevys. This is only offered at Hubler's 5 Chevy dealers. Other dealers cannot give you this peace of mind, and it is peace of mind, real simple. Click drivehublerchevy.com, shop Indiana's largest inventory of Chevys. Find the perfect one at a discounted price. Get the 10-year, 200,000-mile limited warranty for free. December deals include 2018 Silverado, $179 a month. Hubler has the largest selection. 2018 Cruze, $159 a month. Or the new Trax for $149 a month. Hubler is Indiana's Chevy giant and the new home of the 10-year, 200,000-mile limited warranty. Visit any of Hubler's 5 Chevy locations for that incredible deal or click drivehublerchevy.com. Year-end savings end January 1st, obviously. Call 888-221-5101 to score a VIP appointment or click drivehublerchevy.com.
So I got her a Peloton bike and...
I found it. He got me a Peloton.
She still has no idea.
So obvious, right?
I mean, she...
may have dropped a hint or two.
She loves studio workouts.
But I just don't have time to get there.
It's got all kinds of classes. Endurance rides.
30-minute pop rides.
Even country.
His thing, not mine.
I'm definitely riding it too.
I guess he can write it too.
This holiday, give the perfect gift for them and you. Give the gift of Peloton at onepeloton.com or visit your local showroom to try the bike.
Do you need furnace or heat pump service and need to find a local well-trained expert you can trust like Marshall Home Comfort Solutions in Franklin? Find that American Standard Air dealer at IndyHomeComfort.com.
This is Indy Sports Center.
WFNI, WIBC, HD2,
W298BB, W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Colts are in Houston to face the division-leading Texans. Coverage Sunday morning at 10 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Dan Dockage, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Next time, or the first time Indiana plays, and I don't know if they do, I haven't looked at their schedule, but next time they play at Minnesota, I got to get a poll question going about whether or not we like that court at Minnesota. Like, it's bleached white, kind of. Used to be dark and blank knuckle brown. Now, if you don't know what blank knuckle is, it starts with an S, ends with a T, and it's a four-letter word. So there you go. But now it's, you like it? Here, go on. What do you think? We're looking at it right now. BTN's replaying the game. It's weird, right?
It is so white.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like wood.
You know, no. It looked like ice. A little bit of an ice.
It does. It looks a little bit like a hockey rink.
Yeah. And it used to be, I'm curious, I don't know if I go there or not, but when you walked into the arena, Williams Arena, it was a little bit like Mackey, and that was dark all the time. And Mackey really brightened itself up. But this one here, I don't know if I like it. A couple of things, per the Pacers, per David Benner, Domantas Sabonis is questionable for tonight's game. He's got an illness. Frank Reich, according to Mike Chappell at mchappell51, cautiously optimistic T.Y. will be good to go against Houston. That would be good. As Rick Venturi said earlier on our show on Wednesday, that, you know what, T.Y. Hilton is a bit of a killer of the Titans. And the guys that aren't going to play list, Mike Mitchell and Inman, no likey, don't like, because I think Inman's been pretty good. Mo Alie-Cox involved there as well, but Mo Alie-Cox has been out. Inman's been good, man. Mike Mitchell's been good. Mike Mitchell can't stay healthy. Maybe that's why he's been cut, but that ain't great. You know, a couple guys, just to clean up a little bit about what we were talking about yesterday, a couple of guys hit me with, hey, Dan, last time I really thought, right here, that's Dan, last time I really thought about enforcers was the Davis brothers. Pretty true, because in that area, you had enforcers. You had guys that, you know, protected the rim, and occasionally, if while protecting the rim, they got a nice shot to the chops, you got a nice shot to the chops. Dale Davis's son committed to Indiana, and that's awesome. Antonio Davis is one of the nicest guys in America. His son played a couple places. I think he ended up having a pretty good career. Was it Tennessee, maybe? I don't know, but Antonio, his kid was out of Chicago, and just really good dudes, but really tough dudes. And guys that, you know, hey, Smits wasn't afraid to hit you either. Smits wasn't afraid to lay the wood to you. Do you realize in those days when you look back on it, how good you had to be to compete in the NBA? Now think about that. Think about the size across the front line that the Pacers had. And I'm just using those three guys. That doesn't include Crozier. That doesn't include Derek McKee. I mean, think about the size, the versatility of Derek McKee. Think about a Hall of Famer in the backcourt. And probably, is Mark Jackson in the Hall of Fame? He's there too. Jalen Rose was in the doghouse here and there, but you had some really, how good you had to be. Like LeBron James now can take a team and go to the NBA Finals standing on his freaking head in the East, not in the West. I don't think. Maybe he can't. That's the thing you think about as coaches. I remember one time as a player thinking, man, I remember when Coach Knight said I was guarding Michael Jordan. I remember this disgusted look on his face like, oh, man, this should be like Isaiah, right? This is how far Indiana basketball has fallen. And I've thought it too. I look at pictures now and it's like, man, you got Woody out there. You got Whitman out there. You got Butch Carter out there. You got Tolbert out there. You got Landon out there. My God. That's five first-round picks. Serious business. That's five first-round picks playing in 80. And a couple of them were older, like, and I'm using 80, not 81, because Woody was out there. But I'm talking about a senior in Woodson, a senior in Butch Carter, a junior in junior in Tolbert, a junior-ish in Landon. It's like, man, a sophomore in Landon. I mean, it's like, damn, how good was that? Now you kind of watch, and I think the basketball is better. We talked about this yesterday. I think the basketball is better. The game has more flow. The three-point shot has spread defenses, and nobody in this world, I don't care about Rick Mount or anybody that you're going to name. That was one guy. Everybody's Rick Mount now. Everybody makes shots now. I'm talking about 6'11" guys with the last name of Ick or Itch. They make them standing on their freaking head. Like, the truth of the matter is, when you see an open shot now, whether it is college or pro, you think you're shocked when it doesn't go in. You just are. So that was kind of our debate yesterday, and I got to thinking about it. I'm like, yeah, all you got to do is one night, just one night, all you got to do is watch a little ESPN Classic, and you'll see the ball handling isn't close. The spread of offense, not even near. Now, it couldn't be because the three-point shot. Even in 89 when we won the league, after winning the national championship in 87, even in 1989 with a guard-oriented team, and we were very good. Like, don't get me wrong, we were very good at Indiana. You just didn't use a three-point shot. It's fascinating to me. It really was. It's fascinating to watch that the other day. It's like, man. Look at these guys. I mean, wow. So, I don't know. We talking about it yesterday made me think about the Pacers. Like, a lot of people say, hey, Dan, the first Pacer enforcer that they remember was LaSalle Thompson. That sounds about right. LaSalle Thompson was a really good, like, highly recruited kid. I think he played at Texas, but I remember him in high school. And it was one of those deals where, man, that dude, big, strong. But if you're really going to talk about, and I think people do, if you're really going to talk about an enforcer, that would be the Davis brothers. Kind of funny, really. Enforcers just aren't. I would tell you a story about at Iowa in 1989. So we win the Big Ten. We're 15-2. And we win it like on a Sunday, I think. I think it was Wisconsin on a Sunday, right? So we beat Wisconsin, and we got like, Big Ten is clinched. It's at home. We beat Wisconsin. I think Joe Hillman and maybe Todd Jadlow and, you know, Magnus were seniors. So it was Brian Sloan and Cree. Yeah, that's right. Brian Sloan and Cree were seniors. So we win on senior night. And it's great, right? We're 15-2, haven't lost in a while. We go to Iowa. Now, Iowa has a really good team. Iowa was about 10th, 15th, something like that in the country. And we're going to play in Iowa City on their senior night, but we've already clinched it. So Coach Knight decides we're not going to play Jay Edwards. We're not going to play our starter. I don't think Hillman played. I can't really remember. So we're sitting there in a hotel room the night before, right? Coach Knight isn't going to play these guys. So what does my man do? My man Felling says, "Hey, Danny, can you get $10,000 together?" I'm like, "No, why? What are you talking about?" He goes, "We're the only guys that know." I go, "What do you mean the only guys that know?" "We're the only guys that know that, you know, we're going to not play the game." I go, "What are you talking?" He goes, "Hey, if we're ever going to gamble on a game, here it is." I started laughing. I'm like, "You're an idiot. I'm not going to jail for $10,000. Are you insane?" But my boy was always thinking, Felling. Always thinking. My man had it going. My man had it figured out. But I'm just going back to, if you really, really watch, it's like, man, come on. Let's go. What are we doing? Oh, man. 317-239-1070 is the number. dan@1070thefan.com is the email. And as always, we are on Twitter @DanDockage. We need more Indiana guys to call back in. We need Indiana guy to call back in and tell me how Bob Knight hadn't lost momentum. All right, here's a trivia. Here's a trivia question. Will somebody sign Kareem Hunt within the next 2 years? My answer is absolutely. Now, people say to me this. People say to me, "Hey, look, all right, Kareem Hunt is just like Ray Rice. Do you think Ray Rice would have been signed had he not been at the end of his career as opposed to the beginning of his career?" It's the same thing as Coach Knight. You can make up the argument that Ray Rice wasn't signed because of domestic abuse. I would argue Ray Rice wasn't signed certainly because of domestic abuse at the wrong time. Like, I would argue that if Ray Rice had value to a team, and we're going to find out now, because a guy that is a star in Kareem Hunt is now out of the league. He's on the exempt list. Now, you're going to find out, because I'm telling you, if Kareem Hunt, which every team in the league is watching, including the Colts, if there's Colts are no dummies. I'm not saying they're ever going to bring him in. No one's saying that. What I'm saying is, look, every team is following it. Jerry Jones has admitted to following it, but he didn't admit why. He said he was following it because he wanted to see what the league's going to do. This is at the end of his career. That's where Ray Rice was. This is the beginning. What do you got, Chad?
I'm going to say, yeah, the Raiders would sign him. Everybody's career goes there to die, but
including Gruden's, unless there's a move, right?
No, I agree. But the thing is, if you look at the Ray Rice thing and compare it to Kareem Hunt, it's not even remotely close to the same thing. I looked at the Kareem Hunt thing. My friend was laughing, and she's a female, and she was like, that's not even that bad.
Really?
Compared to Ray Rice.
Well, compared to Ray Rice. I mean, Ray Rice, yeah. Kyle and I were talking, Ray Rice knocked her out and dragged her out of the elevator. I mean,
He was like a caveman. He was dragging her out. The thing with Kareem Hunt, yeah, I mean, you don't ever lay your hand on anybody. You don't kick somebody. I agree. But you compare it to Ray Rice, not even remotely close to the same thing. So, yeah, he'll get signed by somebody, but it's going to be somebody like the Raiders or somebody like that who's, you know, who everybody goes there to die.
It's interesting you say that. I appreciate your phone call. I'm going to argue the opposite. I'm going to argue. Well, right, let me back up a second. This whole idea, and I am only talking men to men here. You never touch a woman, ever. Like, I used to tell my players, and one of them actually locked himself in a bathroom so because his girlfriend was hitting him, and he called me. I go, get in the bathroom, lock the door. You never. But this whole man-to-man thing, I always hear people say we never put our hands on anybody. I almost had a punchy guy the other night after the Louisville game. I'm talking about man-to-man here. Never, ever punch a woman, touch a woman, push a woman, grab a woman. Never! I'm talking man to man. Where did this whole thing come from that you never put your hands on me? Hey, if you're going to come at me in a threatening way, why is it that I can't put my hands on you if you're a man? A woman? No. You just run away. That's not negotiable. There's a guy named Matt Walsh. I don't know who Matt Walsh is. But Matt Walsh is saying, look, listen to this title. An NFL player is being condemned for hitting a woman. She hit him too. What happened to gender equity? I'm sorry, Matt Walsh, but I don't agree with that even a little bit. Not even a little bit. I saw the video once, and I can't figure out exactly, like, what the hell happened. People are flying around. I didn't study it. I should, but I didn't study it. But the truth of the matter is, it's not Kareem Hunt's first incident, you know, and you go in the bathroom. You get out of the situation. But this whole idea, about any guy can say whatever they want to a guy, get in his face, do all that kind of stuff, and not expect to get knocked the hell out, I just don't get. I'm sorry, I don't get. What are you supposed to do? Are you just supposed to walk around life being screamed at? That's what I did the other day. Like Jason Benetti, like we're walking and some guy's behind us. We're going to eat and some guy's behind us. Finally, when I heard him call me a batch, I turned around and my wife's like, no. Jason Benetti's like, hey, Dan, what's your favorite 20 foods? And I'm like, don't play me. But I know well enough not to do that. But why can't I do that? If I'm being taunted on the street, why can't a good old fist fight occur? Serious business. Why? Hey, look, I get that it's dangerous. Like, I had a friend die. He got punched in the nose. His nose went back into his head, and he died. I get all that. But the idea of, well, you can't put your hands on somebody else. So I'm just supposed to stand there and let some guy get an inch away from me and scream and yell at me without shoving him away from me? Is that what you're saying? I don't buy it. Who's this?
I think I'm spelling it wrong. You play for Purdue.
What's up, Steve?
How you doing today?
Good.
Do you know who Billy Keller is?
Sure.
Well, the guy that answered the phone doesn't.
Okay. So what?
I'm going to hang up, but I want your opinion of Billy Keller because I think he was a much better ball player than Mount.
I'm way too young for that. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm very young. I don't remember either of them. When I see Billy Keller working with kids, I think he's very good. And when I see Rick Mount, it's only been at the top of the bleachers at Lebanon High School. I don't remember either. I'm very young. So, I mean, good, bad, happy, or sad. I'm sorry. I don't know. I can't answer. Well, the guy on the phone didn't. The dude on the phone's 24 years old. 24 years ago was like, what? What is this, 19? Or it's 94. Were you born in 94? 95. Yikes. Come on. Said it like it's a derogatory. Do you know who Satch is? No. Guy on the phone. Lee Ross and I have a new, podcast out. Dan, explain yourself. Mark Boyle joined us. Give you a great idea for holiday gifts. Give you a great idea into the mind, the life, the times of Mark Boyle, the life of Lee and Dan. It's really a fascinating, fascinating listen. Go to 1070thefan.com. Am I wrong? I mean, do you think, like, should a guy be able, if you come up in my face, am I not allowed to shove you away from me? And then whatever happens from there, we just got to deal with? Am I wrong about that? Because it's happening to me like every freaking time I go do a game now. Every time some freaking idiots, you know, are like, hey, dog, it's you, blah, 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 blah. Come on up here. We're going to kick your, all right, I'm right here. I mean, I say it all the time, right? So what happens if they come down? What do I got to do? Right or wrong, this is different from Ray Rice. This isn't domestic violence. Him and his woman had no prior relationship, so this is assault, and I don't care about him fighting with those dudes. Sometimes dudes need to get punched, is what I'm saying. So someone will definitely sign him. Many owners are just waiting for the facts surrounding. The only problem I have, Fresh Face, with that, the only problem I have is, what's the right word to put it? What's the right way to put it? More stuff is coming out. You know what I mean? More fresh phrases. The speed difference in basketball is staggering. Same with the NFL. Size of these guys and maintaining speed is such a difference between the 80s and now. Let me tell you something, Fresh Face. I was shocked yesterday when I heard Maurice Lucas only was 6'8", 215. Shocked. Like, I thought Maurice Lucas was the biggest you've ever seen. Biggest, baddest mofo you've ever seen. I can say mofo on the air, right? Biggest, I thought he was, and then I read he's 6'8", 215. That's like, that's less than freaking Derek McKee back in the day. Reggie Miller was probably 215. No, he wasn't. It shocked me when I read that. The speed now, like I was, I'll be honest with you, I was kind of surprised that, Andrew was able to play last year. I really was, because it's a fast game. Hey, Dan, come on, idiot callers. It's Friday. You can do better than Mount versus Keller. I can't. I'm sorry. I can't go into Mount versus Keller. Hey, Dan, if you could punch a guy every now and then, people would be nicer. Duh. Dan, you catch more ish from people when in bars than anyone I've ever been around. It's not close. Right. And I'm not mad about it. Topper, what do you got? Give me a quick one.
Dan, here's the issue. They know that you're from the region and you're an easy mark, first of all. And then second of all, you got a lot more to lose than they do if you take matters into your own hands. So,
first time I was ever doing a remote from a bar, I told the sales ladies, look, I shouldn't do remotes from bars. It was right after the Indiana thing. A friend of mine named Stroke, his buddy, and I got in a kind of a discussion. It turned into an argument. He broke a glass and was going to stab me. And it was over, like, whether Lou Holtz cheated or not. And I looked at the salespeople. I go, I told you. The world's crazy. I'm just a nice guy with a baby face. What the hell? Goodbye. We'll talk to you. Hey, we come back. We're going to win you some money. Don't miss Doug Kazarian. He's won us a blank load of money over the last few weeks. He's going to do it again today with NFL games. And coming up later on, Kevin Bowen talking Colts. And David Bell from Warren Central, the winningest guy ever, like in the world of high school sports. He's going to win another one this year at Warren Central.
Do you have a love-hate relationship with your credit card? You love the freedom and convenience the credit card gives you, but you hate the high interest rates? And let's face it, they're high. 17, 18, even 20% APR? That's pretty outrageous. But with Lightstream's credit card consolidation loan, rather than throwing your money away on high interest payments, you can get a much lower rate, as low as 6.14% APR with AutoPay. And today, if you want an even lower rate, apply at lightstream.com/radio for a special discount. Plus, with Lightstream, your rate is fixed, so as rates continue to rise, your rates won't budge. They'll stay low. You can get a loan from $5,000 to $100,000, which means you can pay off your credit card and start paying an interest rate you can really love, thanks to Lightstream.
Ready to start saving? Apply now at lightstream.com/radio. That's right. Get your extra discount by applying today at lightstream.com/radio. That's lightstream.com/radio.
Subject to credit approval. Rate includes 0.5% auto pay discount. Terms and conditions apply and offers are subject to change without notice. Visit lightstream.com/radio for more information.
There are times in life when certain situations are unavoidable. As life passes, we get a little slower and a little more achy than the year before. All part of life. But when we lose the ability for intimacy with the one we love, it can feel much worse. Unfortunately, the lady we love typically feels like this situation is just because of her. As men, we know that's just not true. We want that spark back just as much as she does. The Indianapolis Men's Clinic physicians hear this from struggling couples every day. Fortunately, that struggle in your relationship from erectile dysfunction can be gone. One simple visit to the Indianapolis Men's Clinic with a same-day solution. The joy of your relationship will be back. And the best part of it is seeing that spark back in a happy relationship. Call 999-9000. It's simple, safe, and private. 999-9000. Clinic visit, evaluation, and testing is just $99. IndyMensClinic.com for more information. 999-9000.
Hey, Dad. I wanted to remind you that the holidays are close. Real close. And Mom and I don't need wool socks again. At Helzberg, you can get jewelry for Mom and get a free Nintendo Switch system for me. Two gifts in one trip. I'm not saying you're a last-minute shopper, but I'm not saying that either.
Get gifts that get gifts at Helzberg Diamonds, like a free Nintendo Switch system when you spend $1,199 or more. Helzberg Diamonds, a Berkshire Hathaway company. Limited time offer while supplies last. See online or in-store for details. Game sold separately.
Hey, Michael Grady here for the good folks over at Payless Liquors in the 26 locations around Central Indiana. And we're in December, the holiday season. You can stop in to get some great deals right now. Crown Royal Indiana Glassware Gift Sets, $22.99 while supplies last. Smirnoff Holiday Ornaments, $9.99 while supplies last. Jack Daniels, 1.75 liters, Black Label, just $39.99. And their next bourbon event is coming up December 12th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Adams Street Carmel location. Why pay more, get more, and pay less at Payless Liquors.
When my hair's too long, I'm not on my game. But after a haircut at Great Clips, I'm
a new man. My voice sounds like this when I barbecue raw meat.
At the gym, my abdominals abdominate. I can do that Elvis thing with my lower lip. And allergies? They become allergic to me.
Get back to greatness. With Clip Notes, get the cut you want every time, anywhere. Great Clips. It's going to be great.
When you're hiring, some job boards make you sort through tons of the wrong resumes, which makes finding a great candidate like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. That's not smart. Then, there's the smart way at ZipRecruiter. Unlike other job sites, ZipRecruiter finds great candidates for you. That's why you should try it now for free. Their powerful matching technology scans thousands of resumes to identify people with the right skills, education, and experience, and actively invites them to apply to your job, so you get qualified candidates fast. And while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds what you're looking for, the needle in the haystack.
ZipRecruiter is rated number one by employers in the U.S. That's based on hiring sites on Trustpilot with over 1,000 reviews. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And right now, you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Purchase $100 in Massage Envy gift cards between now and December 31st and receive vouchers for two free session enhancements. Massage Envy membership, making the best of everybody.
Looking for the latest updates about the Indianapolis Colts? Then Kevin's got you covered. Check out Kevin's Corner at 1070thefan.com. The latest Colts news brought to you by Great Clips.
Golic and Wingo.
Houston, I like what they're doing right now.
I think the Colts are better.
I think the Colts are better, too.
Now, what would make you say the Colts are better?
The way Andrew Luck is now playing, 8 straight games with 3 touchdown passes.
The Colts' defense isn't as good as Houston's defense.
When you talk about a run game, I'm taking the Colts group up front every day and twice. No disrespect. Here comes the disrespect.
Yeah, get to the O-line. I'm definitely taking the Colts.
Golic and Wingo. Weekdays 6 to 10 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan. Dan Dockage, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Keep this up. Don't let this go. This is the greatest song. Keep this played high. This is the best song of the disco era. I'm telling you, when this came on my driveway on my little radio that I had, I was jumping. I was dunking. I couldn't dunk. I was dunking. I was, oh, you kidding me? Burn, baby, burn. Burn, baby, burn. Burn, baby, burn. Doug Kazarian knows. He's going to win some money here because that's what he does. But this is the greatest song in the disco era, and no one can tell me different. I don't care what you say. I don't care. To my surprise. Doug Kazarian is too young to know this song, but if you don't know this song, then I hate on you because this is literally the greatest song in the worst era of fashion in the history of the United States, although now is coming close. Disco Inferno by the Tramps. Put it on your playlist. Hi, Doug Kazarian. How are you?
How dare you, Dan Dockage. My fraternity had a 70s party called Disco Inferno that was ranked in Playboy.
Wow.
So I'm appalled.
I stand here naked in front of you. Shame. 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 Where'd you go to school?
I went to Brown.
Oh, yeah, you did. Now, Men's Health says Brown hates men. The two worst schools for men to go to and are discriminated against are Brown and Oberlin College in Ohio University. Your reaction to that?
Nonsense. Nonsense. Okay. Look, I went to college in the end of the 90s, and it was sort of that shift that, you know, there was that narrative that Harvard had all the preppy guys with golf shirts with the collars popped up, and Brown had a bunch of dudes who were, you know, long cargo pants.
Yeah.
Long hair. Like, nowadays, every admissions office wants everything. So they all want valedictorians. They all want, you know, liberals. They all want conservatives. They all want sort of the balanced enrollment. So all the stereotypes are out the door.
Do you think, because I went to this party at a fraternity, do you know who Jim Jones is in the Kool-Aid of Jonestown, South Africa, wherever it was?
No, I do not.
Okay. Well, I went to a Jim Jones party where they served Kool-Aid. If you look it up, I mean, if they did that right now, everybody would have been kicked off the campus. Everybody would have been. It was basically mass murder, and they made a freshman kid sit.
Oh, Jonestown.
Jonestown, yeah.
Yeah, sorry. I didn't realize you were going there.
Yeah. I went to a party like that in college. I walked in, and I'm like, one of my friends, I go, why is that dude sitting there on stage in a white robe with shades on, and why are you only serving Kool-Aid? They're like, well, it's a Jonestown party. I'm like, oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's a little strange more than anything.
I would be kicked off the basketball team for going. In fact, I'm nervous that I might get kicked off this station because I went to a party in the fall of 81. You know what I mean?
Right.
Don't comment.
We all evolve. We all evolve.
Yeah. And actually, I kind of like the Kool-Aid and vodka. I wasn't mad at it. But anyway, Coach, let's talk this weekend in the NFL because I believe. But before that, let's talk Heisman. Give me 2 weeks ago. It's 2A. Now who's going to win this thing? And talk to me about the odds that you're seeing.
Well, it's fascinating what's happened. I mean, since the beginning of the season, not opening in the spring, but since the beginning of the season, Tua was opened the college football season as the favorite. And he stayed the favorite, and that number went all the way up to the point where this was a foregone conclusion, engraved the trophy. And then like 3 weeks ago, he was a 1-10 favorite, so minus 1,000 on the money line. Then last week, it got down to minus 400 or 500. And then after conference championship weekend, they reposted. Now, this currently, Kyler Murray is the favorite.
Wow.
Big shift, but I will say this, and I just talked to an offshore odds maker literally moments before I got on this call, and that the Monday reposting of the odds, they had Tua still the favorite at like minus 300. But so many people bet Kyler Murray's an underdog Monday. Remember, we talk about this a lot. The betting public remembers what they last saw. And I know of plenty of sharp guys who have Tua at long odds from the offseason, like 30 to 1, 20 to 1, that a lot of people realized that it was a close race and started hedging their bets. So there was an influx of money, and that's what moved Murray. Murray wasn't reposted Monday as the favorite. He became the favorite after the reposting on Monday.
What, all right, what's the odds on it? What when you say favorite, what kind of action can you get on
it? He's like 2-1. Murray's like a 2-1 favorite.
Wow.
Right now.
No kidding.
To my 200.
Interesting stuff, because, you know, one of those football guys a week or two ago said Murray has become the favorite. And I thought, nah, come on, stop it. But then all of a sudden you watch last weekend and it's like, well, I imagine so, right? I mean, looks that way to me. What the hell?
Officially, Murray is the betting favorite right now.
Yeah.
But he didn't open this week as the betting favorite, right? So a lot of people assume that, like, after the conference championship weekend, Murray was reposted as the favorite. The key is the odds makers still favored Tua after last weekend. Just the betting action from Monday forward has moved it to Murray favored. Now, that doesn't mean, you know, one or the other. I just think it's a lot tighter than we thought.
Yeah.
First time all season, Tua is not the betting favorite.
Man, interesting stuff, man.
I think Tua wins. I think Tua wins, but that's just me.
Yeah, and because, so people understand, sometimes the favorite isn't who they think is going to win. It's just to move the line to balance out the action, right? I mean, you don't want all the action on one side, then you get smacked around.
Right, and also it's important that this was an event that started last spring, last year, last championship, when the Heisman odds were posted. And so a lot of people who have Tua at long odds, like 30 to 1, 20 to 1, decided Monday to hedge their bet, and that moved the market as well.
Yeah.
So I talked to a guy at the Superbook, one of the head odds makers, and he said they lose money regardless of Murray or Tua. They lose money with either guy.
Well, they don't need to be doing that too many times, or else they're going to be closing shop. So let's, you know,
yeah.
Hey.
Well, the beauty is that the betting public will give it back. Not all of them.
Really?
An odds maker told me this going into the season. He's like, we don't want to win every NFL weekend. We want to lose a few, because when they win, they'll keep coming back and lose it anyway. So we can't just bury them for 17 straight weeks, because then we won't have any action by like week 10.
No, that makes total sense. All right, give me some NFL things that you like. What do you like this week? Interesting week.
Well, first, we got a college game, right?
Yes.
Start Army Navy. How about this, Docket? You like trends, right?
I do.
We got 12 straight years Army-Navy has gone under the total.
12 straight years. So, let me ask you, are they due to go over, or is this a trend we believe in?
Well, I think it's interesting because it's a trend we believe in, because the power ratings that determine the over-under are determined by this season. So Army and Navy, their power ratings are based on playing other teams all year.
Right.
The reason I think the trend exists is because these defenses are accustomed to facing one another every week in practice, whereas Georgia Tech surprises their opponents all year, right? We saw the Georgia Tech game fly over the total. So Army-Navy defenses face each other, so the elements of the triple option are not that foreign. On top of that, because you're getting only 3 yards instead of chunk plays of 15 yards, that lends itself, the running game does lend itself to the under. So I like the under.
It's 40.
Yeah, it's 40.
Wow.
But, man, you know, look, they get a couple first downs, punt, couple first downs, and all of a sudden it's the end of the first quarter.
No, you're right. No, I've watched both of those teams play, and if you're prepared for the other, it can be a grind, and it can, no question about it. You like the under. Do you like Army to win the game?
Oh, I don't know. I've bet the under each of the last few years.
Oh, I gotcha.
But, you know, of course you do. They're 7-point favorites. It's a remarkable year for Army.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, Coach Ken will have something up his sleeve.
Love that guy. That guy comes on the show and he knocks it out of the park.
Yeah. Great.
All right, what do you like?
Give me some last name?
What's that?
You ever try to pronounce his last name?
Yeah, they put it phonetically for me. Scott Strassmeyer, the SID, is a friend of mine, so he makes sure I don't look like an idiot, and I'm not even going to begin to say it as you and I are talking right now. So, yes.
Yeah.
Papa the baby. Yeah. That's it. I'll say what you could. Right, you could have said. You could have said Ed, and I'd have said yes. Right.
I got two NFL plays for you. I'm going to start with the Broncos at the 49ers. Look, these are two teams headed in opposite directions. Broncos have won three straight. They're 6-1 against the point spread in their last seven. They've been making a push to the playoff berth. So much of that division has been fixated on the Chiefs and Chargers, which is fair. But the Broncos are kind of hitting their stride. And the San Francisco team, they have a lot more issues than just Jimmy G being out. They're in pole position for the top overall pick. I'd say these two things are going to continue trending. I like the Broncos -4, which seems like a short number. I know it's on the road, but it's 3.5 or 4. I'll lay it.
I like that pick a lot. I think the Broncos are playing well. I do. And I think the 49ers may be the poster child for give up. Hey, you know what's amazing? What's a guy's name? Lynch? What's his name? The GM of the 49ers?
John Lynch.
John Lynch. A year ago, he was like the hero. A year ago, he was a genius. Now they've got issues coming out the wazoo, and he ain't no genius no more until you win some games. All right, what else you like?
Monday night, ooh. How do you feel about Kirk Cousins? Where do you stand on him?
I said this. I said when Minnesota got Kirk Cousins, they didn't get any better. I could be wrong. Give me your take.
I agree. They might have a better quarterback, but last year there's no way they could have gotten better quarterback play
right.
from anyone, including Tom Brady. That season was remarkable.
Yes.
So I expected a step back. But now that Cousins got his contract, he got the keys to the castle, no longer had to worry about that Dan Snyder, Redskins stench. I just think he's kind of soft. I think the whole Vikings team is soft. And this is a Monday night game that's interesting because you have one team that's much better on paper. I think the Vikings are just better than the Seahawks on paper. But this is Seattle at home, and I'm going to trust Russell Wilson in this spot much more than I do Cousins. I'll lay the 3 against a team that Kirk Cousins, get this, as a starter, he's 8-19 against teams with winning records. So not exactly raising his level of competition because he's had enough weapons in Minnesota. They just don't get it done. They've only had one impressive win, a relatively impressive win, and that's at home against Green Bay. And that's a Packers team that is winless this entire season on the road and just fired its head coach. So I'm not even going to say that's that impressive of a win. So that's all the Vikings have done. They've beaten up bad teams. They lose to the good teams. I'll take the Seahawks -3.
Let me ask you about a couple teams. You don't have to really talk about the betting, but I'm going to ask you, believer or not believer, are you a believer in the Dallas Cowboys? I saw today somebody, I think it was on Philadelphia, they play Philadelphia, the 3-point favorites. Are you a believer in the Dallas Cowboys?
I think they win the division, but I think this little run is just setting the Cowboys fans up for heartache come postseason because I don't believe in Dak Prescott.
Are you a believer in the Los Angeles Chargers as a viable contender now that Kareem Hunt's out with the Chiefs and obviously the Patriots? You believe in the Chargers?
Loosely. Loosely believe in them. They've shot themselves in the foot way too often. I would still take the Chiefs over them in a hummingbird's heartbeat, especially in cold weather, because they're going to have to go to Kansas City. I still think the Chiefs are loaded and the team to beat right now. I think they're just a little bored. They're not covering these double-digit spreads like last week against Oakland. I still don't believe in the Chargers.
Colts play.
I thought the Steelers got outcoached last week.
I did too, in a weird way, which I never really see in the NFL. Houston has won 9 in a row. The Colts play Houston. It's a 4.5-point spread. Colts getting the points. What would be your advice on that?
That is a tough one.
Yeah, I agree.
I have been sort of like waiting for the other shoe to drop, if that makes sense, with the Houston Texans in this win streak. I just haven't been big believers. But maybe it's all coming together. Deshaun Watson had the knee injury. It takes some time to come back. Obviously, we're seeing that with Carson Wentz, right? He had the injury later in the season in December, so he has yet to kind of work out the kinks, the rust, if you will. So Watson needed those first few weeks to come back to his dominant self, right? And then you have this D-line that had issues with injuries, whether it be J.J. Watt, Jadeveon Clowney. Finally, they're putting it all together. So, yes, their current sort of game plan is not to blow you out like the Chiefs are. Defense, field position, make a few plays with Hopkins and a running game. So while they only beat the Redskins by 2 points, they only beat the Broncos by 2 points. They've had close games during this win streak, a one-score win over Buffalo and Dallas and Indy earlier this year. That's their intention how to win. So I think you have to give them credit and start being believers of them now. I definitely think they're the favorites in the division, obviously.
There you go, man. The great Doug Kazarian. Doug, I appreciate you, my friend. Thank you so much. Give me the podcast info and where people can go.
It's Behind the Bets, and it's either on iTunes, ESPN Pod Center. We talk with the Vegas odds makers. We have all sorts of good stuff. We have picks. How about this for a record? Tomorrow I got to do another pick. I'm probably doing Army-Navy under. 27-12 this year on SportsCenter in my college football pick.
Damn! Give Shaw the man his monies.
Blind squirrel, right?
No. You are anything but a blind squirrel. You are an informed, handsome gentleman. There you go. Appreciate you, my friend. I'll talk to you. Thank you.
Who's willing to hit up a 70s party?
Yeah. Oh, man, it's the best. It's the best. Look, that's Doug Kazarian, Four Winds Lakeside, NM Marine Hotline. Always like, I'm telling you, he's been winning. So he likes to recap under, oh, man, I don't know about under 40. That's under 40. Ooh, I'm going to take Army and give you the 6.5. I think Army, but he likes under 40 in the Army-Navy game. He likes the Broncos -3.5, which I absolutely love. If you can get rid of that hook, that'd be even better. And he likes the Seahawks -3, so there you go. I hate the hook. The hook will drive you bat blank crazy. Bookie odds on the next Packers coach. I'll give you those. Also, your phone calls. Top of the hour, Kevin Bowen, right? All right, don't leave. We are on YouTube. YouTube.com. Search 1070 The Fan.
This year, I need to get her a gift that says, I know I watch a lot of football, and thanks for being okay with that.
I'm looking for the present that makes the statement, I know I've been working a lot lately, and I really appreciate your help with the kids.
I'm looking for the, I know I don't say it enough, but I feel like the luckiest guy in the world to have you in my life present.
I'm BJ Nichols. When it comes to gift giving, it's the thought that counts. And no matter what the thought is behind your gift, you'll find the perfect one at Reese Nichols Jewelers. Go to ReeseNichols.com to see our holiday hit list, the season's top picks.
I need to find them. Aren't you impressed considering I never have time to shop gift?
Then you'll love this. At ReeseNichols.com, you can buy online, ship for free, or swing by our store to pick it up, wrapped and ready to go. We make your holiday shopping easy at Reese Nichols Jewelers. Keystone at the Crossing in Greenwood or online at ReeseNichols.com.
Even the please forgive me, I know I screwed up thought?
Oh yeah, we have a lot of those too.
This is a shout out to the professional tailgaters, game day grillers, and potluck pros. Whether you bake it, smoke it, stack it, or melt it, there's nothing more important than how you cook up your team spirit while serving it with an ice cold Coca-Cola or Coke Zero Sugar. We may not all agree on the best game day foods, but when you serve your meals with a Coke, you know you've got yourself a winner. Pick up a custom Colts commemorative cup at your nearest Arby's. Coca-Cola, taste the feeling.
The joy of giving really comes to life when it's been a good year. And let's face it, 2018's been a very good year, with a booming economy and lots to be thankful for. So why not make this the year to show her what she truly means to you? And splurge with a spectacular gift from Diamonds Direct. Maybe a gorgeous pair of 3-carat diamond stud earrings, or a spectacular 10-carat diamond tennis bracelet. Or how about a special piece of jewelry from a world-class designer? At Diamonds Direct, we've stocked up for the holiday season with our most impressive selection ever. Gifts from $300 to $300,000. And now till the end of December, we're offering 3 years zero interest financing on any purchase. So you can splurge with confidence and spread your payments over 3 years without a dime in interest on approved credit. So celebrate. Celebrate the good year. And most importantly, celebrate her with an unforgettable gift from Diamonds Direct. Check out our holiday gift guide in store or online now at DiamondsDirect.com. Diamonds Direct, with extended hours including open every Sunday in December.
Keystone at the Crossing.
Hey, does your company need stronger talent to grow your business? Without the best talent, it's hard to win. Just like in hoops, football, you name it, Joe Huffine and Kingsley Rose are helping companies all over the country in multiple industries recruit top talent. I went and met with them. They're awesome. Private equity firms, multi-billion dollar firms, and small companies are hiring Joe Huffine and Kingsley Rose to build management teams, sales teams, operations, and IT teams. Need a CFO, sales leader, or CIO? Visit Kingsley-Rose.com, one of the only retained search firms in Indianapolis. Kingsley-Rose.com. Promise you, really good.
Hey, this time of year, you're spending a lot of money using that card all the time. It's JMV for Farm Credit Union. How can you save this time of year? Well, get with Farm Credit Union and my friend Trevor Green. Smart ways to help pay for those extra holiday spending needs. Always genius, always original. It's Farm Credit Union. Ask for Trevor Green. Slide by a branch location today. Or for more information, it is incredibly easy online, farmcu.com, to ask for a personal loan option today.
Hey, Dan Dockage here for my friends at Hubler Chevrolet. Listen up, because Hubler is changing how you buy a vehicle. The 10-year, 200,000-mile limited warranty on all Chevrolets is changing the world. Seriously, it's unbelievable. It's only offered at Hubler Chevrolet and at their five dealerships. Other dealers cannot give you this peace of mind. Real simple. Click drivehublerchevy.com and shop Indiana's largest inventory of Chevys. Find the perfect one at a discounted price and get a 10-year, 200,000-mile limited warranty for free. December deals include 2018 Silverado, only $179 per month. High on Hubler has the largest selection. It's the greatest truck ever built. Cruise, $158. Trax, $148. Hubler is Indiana's Chevy giant. New home of 10 years, 200,000-mile limited warranty. Visit any of Hubler's five Chevrolet dealerships or click drivehublerchevy.com. Year-end savings end January 1st, 888-221-5101 to score a VIP appointment or click drivehublerchevy.com. Tell Brooke and the team Daniel J. Dackish sent you.
It's The Morning After featuring Jeff Saturday. Everything you need to know about the Colts game the day before. Only on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan.
All aboard!
Dan Dockage, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan.
Yeah, I don't get this. I'm sorry, but Matthew Adams, the Colts linebacker, rookie who I love, he hits hard. He got fined $26,739 for his hit on Cody Kessler. You could not have come in any different. I'm sorry, but the NFL, my ass. I mean, that's ridiculous to me. It's absolutely ridiculous to me that he gets fined that. Must be a game check or something. Honest to God, I mean, it's incredible to me. It really is. It's incredible to me that you get fined for that particular hit. I mean, I understand if you want to give him a nonsensical, $10,000 and let the team, but you, that's a, man, I don't get that. I honestly don't. I mean, I know I'm supposed to, and I know we're all supposed to say, well, they're cleaning up the game, but that hit in particular, I thought at the time it happened and I saw it on replay, I don't know what you do. I mean, I really don't. And that's just, I don't know, man. That did not seem right that kid got that kind of fine. All right, memo to all Colts and all running backs. Yesterday, the Purdue game gets over. I literally just flip channels and I go to the NFL game and that kid Henry is going for 99 yards. He's going for 99 yards. And here is the reason why I thought it was incredibly good. Because he could have done with what every freaking player running back in the NFL does, not named beast mode. Derrick Henry could have run out of bounds. And Lee and I go, and we're like, why is that guy run out of bounds? Why doesn't he try to split him? Why doesn't he try to stiff arm? Why doesn't he try to do that? Nobody does that in the NFL anymore. And I get it, it's a business decision, but it was so nice to see one guy turn into the field, one guy go stiff arm, one guy take on somebody. And you know what? Walter Payton used to do this and said that's why he never got hurt, because he always delivered the blow. It was so nice to see Derrick Henry do it. I'm a huge Derrick Henry fan. He seems like an awfully nice guy. But he turned into the defenders like running backs used to do, as opposed to just walking out of bounds when he could have gotten 2 to 6 more yards. Hell, he got 50 more, 60 more, actually. I think they first corralled him, or I thought he was first going to go out of bounds on the 30, maybe 70 yards. But you know what happened? So by having some satchel and by staying and taking on people, my man set an NFL record that literally can never be broken. How about that? How about that action? That's strong. That's damn strong. It can never be broken. Ha! There you go. Because, I'm sorry, I just put a thing of sunflower seeds in my mouth, and I really don't know why I did it. But now all of a sudden, he's got records, people. He's got records, and you can't touch him. How about that action? All right, we come back. We're going to talk some Colts stuff with our friend K-Love, Kevin Bowen, and we'll see what he has to say about the Colts. Colts injury list is out and includes some names that I don't like. I wish they weren't on the injury list. And then bottom of the hour, David Bell from Warren Central is going to join. We'll come back. Dan Dockett Show, Kevin Bowen next, talking Colts.
Well, that was ugly.
Jaguars 6, the Colts nothing.
All right, time to shake it off and start a new winning streak.
And it is caught! Touchdown!
Join us this Sunday as the Colts head to Houston for a showdown with the division-leading Texans. Coverage starts at 10. Matt Taylor and Jim Sorgi have the play-by-play at 1. Only on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan. Your exclusive home for the Indianapolis Colts.
Hey, Dan Dockett here for DriveHublerChevy.com. Go to DriveHublerChevy and shop the largest selection of Chevys in the country, or at least in the state. DriveHublerChevy.com.
Hey guys, good news. The outrageously expensive little blue pill is now generic, which means you can get the prescription medication to treat ED at affordable prices, and Hims makes it extra affordable. Right now, get your first month supply for free. All you pay is just $5 for your medical consultation when you go to forhims.com/perform. After that, it's just $30 for a month's supply. Sure beats paying big bucks for just one blue pill, doesn't it? Plus, you won't need an awkward in-person doctor's appointment to get the prescription. Hims has doctors online who can prescribe the medication, and a pharmacy sends it right to your door. It's affordable, private, and incredibly easy. Nobody likes dealing with ED. Now, thanks to Hims, nobody has to. And that's really good news. To get your first order for just $5, you need to go to this exclusive address, forhims.com/perform. That's forhims.com/perform for your first month for just $5. forhims.com/perform.
Hey, Michael Grady here for the good folks over at Payless Liquors in the 26 locations around Central Indiana. And we're in December, the holiday season. You can stop in to get some great deals right now. Crown Royal Indiana Glassware Gift Sets, $22.99 while supplies last. Smirnoff Holiday Ornaments, $9.99 while supplies last. Jack Daniels, 1.75 liters, Black Label, just $39.99. And their next bourbon event is coming up December 12th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Adams Street Carmel location. Why pay more, get more, and pay less at Payless Liquors.
Chad and Tyler Peterman.
It's that time of year when drains get clogged, but no worry. Peterman Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing will get it moving again.
Got a clogged drain in your home? Peterman will unclog that drain for just $83.
That's $83 to unclog any drain.
You don't pay a cent until the drain is clear.
And we'll keep that drain clear with a one-year guarantee.
Call 859-4270. Call Peterman for heating, cooling, and plumbing.
Hey, it's JMV. The Colts and the Cowboys hook up, and you don't want to miss this. Get to the BullseyeEventGroup.com. Colts VIP tailgate presented by Hayes & Sons Restoration. All you can eat, all you can drink, celebrity chef Aaron May, music, our radio show, and you can combo all this up. Tickets to the game, parking, and the Colts VIP tailgate presented by Hayes & Sons Restoration at BullseyeEventGroup.com. It is spectacular. Your game day experience is made. Log on right now, BullseyeEventGroup.com.
Hey, Dad, I wanted to remind you that the holidays are close, real close, and Mom and I don't need wool socks again. At Helzberg, you can get jewelry for Mom and get a free Nintendo Switch system for me. Two gifts in one trip. I'm not saying you're a last-minute shopper, but I'm not saying that either.
Get gifts that get gifts at Helzberg Diamonds, like a free Nintendo Switch system when you spend $1,199 or more. Helzberg Diamonds, a Berkshire Hathaway company. Limited time offer, while supplies last. See online or in-store for details. Game sold separately.
Golic and Wingo.
Houston, I like what they're doing right now.
I think the Colts are better.
I think the Colts are better, too.
Now, what would make you say the Colts are better?
The way Andrew Luck is now playing, 8 straight games with 3 touchdown passes.
The Colts' defense isn't as good as Houston's defense.
When you talk about a run game, I'm taking the Colts group up front every day and twice. No disrespect. Here comes the disrespect.
Yeah, to the O-line, I'm definitely taking the Colts.
Golic and Wingo. Weekdays, 6 to 10 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan. The season is still early. The Pacers are finding their way in the East.
Ahead to Turner, he'll take it in.
And you can hear every play of every game on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Oladipo.
Next up for the Blue and Gold, the Pacers head to Orlando to take on the Magic. Tonight at 6:30, Mark Boyle has the call.
6 seconds to go. 3 ball.
On FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan, your home for Pacers basketball. The Ride with JMV.
And I know that everybody's supposed to be happy. I mean, what did I pick them at the start of the season? 7-9. Oh, well, hold on a minute. They are who we thought they were. And that might be the case, but they were in position. Certainly, you're going to have to win out. And win out starts coming up on Sunday in Houston. But I was completely disappointed.
The Ride with JMP. Weekdays from 3 till 6 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan. This is Indy Sports Center.
WFNI, WIBC, HD2.
W298 BB, W228 CX, Indianapolis. The newest addition to The Fan, Kevin Bowen, who covers the Colts and Pacers. It's Kevin's Corner, on air with Dan Dockage on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
K-Love, here we go. It's the Colts. It is, well, I mean, this would have been a hell of a matchup had the Colts won last week. Colts and the Houston Texans. Texans on a 9-game winning streak. I did not necessarily like the injury report, Kevin. I thought Inman's giving him some good minutes, obviously, and I thought Mitchell the same. I didn't like those two guys being out. You?
Yeah, I would agree, Dan. I've seen far better Friday injury reports for the Colts this season, especially as of late. It's really been, outside of Ryan Kelly, a relatively healthy team here over the past month or so. Like you said, Dontrell Inman has been your number two wideout. It has not been Ryan Grant. Ryan Grant has had 4 catches in the last month. Dontrell Inman has been a very nice in-season signing for you, so he will not play Sunday. Ryan Kelly out for a 3rd straight game. Mitchell is a loss when you go into sub-packages, but he is no longer an every-snap guy. It's become Clayton Gathers and Malik Hooker back in those roles. Those two should play as well. And then the 4th guy ruled out was Mo Alie-Cox, which I think it is a big loss. Mm-hmm. You know, without Jack Doyle, Alie-Cox is about the closest thing you have to at least filling the multiple responsibilities that Doyle usually has. You know, Eric Ebron is not that guy. So definitely some key guys on the offensive side of the ball out on Sunday.
All right, 6 straight quarters, no points. Not played well in 6 straight quarters. Really haven't played. I mean, defense has been fine. But – is this, like, do you think this is a trend? Like, I've asked everybody, is this a trend or is this like, hey, look, you know, you go through this in the NFL, still a good team, that kind of thing?
I think the question I have right now, Dan, with them offensively is, can you withstand some of these injuries? I think that's starting to catch up to them, just the overall depth of your roster. I thought the Colts could sneak into the playoffs if they remained healthy. Because I do think, you know, guys like T.Y. Hilton and Jack Doyle and Ryan Kelly can get the job done. But you lose one, you lose two. Now you're having to manufacture other spots. Like, going into Sunday, it's like, okay, you have Ryan Kelly out. Now Anthony Costanzo's a little banged up. He didn't practice today. Now you feel like you might need a help on the offensive line to protect against Watt and Clowney. Well, then you need pass catchers. Well, now Hilton's a little banged up. And you don't have Dontrell Inman and Jack Doyle is out of the lineup. So that's the balance that Frank Reich faces right now. And I think it's just caught up to them here in recent weeks. And going away from home, I think, is the next step. You know, when you won 5 straight, 4 of those games were at home. And last week, Jacksonville got a little momentum early on, and they rode that the rest of the way.
Yeah, because they looked god-awful last night. I mean, I just thought they looked god-awful. Did you see the play when Jalen Ramsey, you know, flexed and then flopped? Did you see any of that?
Yeah, with Taylor Lewan.
Yeah. How about that? Like, the dude was all pro to last week, and now he's acting like a fool.
Jalen Ramsey's like in-game 60-minute antics are always something to say. I mean, last week he acted like he was going to pick up Andrew Luck on that ugly little slide, and then he pulls the hand away. And Jacksonville last night looked like the team that had lost seven straight, and that is a game we will point to certainly here in about a month if the Colts do indeed miss the playoffs. Is if you want to play in January, you can't lose to the listless and Jaguars, a team at that point. That hadn't won in, you know, 2 months.
That's why, I mean, I've said this, Rick said this, I know Venturi said this, but that interception early was big. That interception huge. To me was absolutely, yeah, huge, right? Absolutely huge.
That gave them life.
Right.
You know, they had just turned the ball over. If you go and punch that, or honestly, if you just get points there, 3 points, that was a 3rd and 9 that Andrew Luck forced that ball down the field to Eric Ebron. If you watch the all 22 over the headshot view, those Jacksonville DBs are just locked in zone coverage, looking right at Andrew Luck's eyes. And, yes, Quentin Nelson gets beat. Calais Campbell is forcing, you know, Luck to scramble a little bit to his right. But if he can check that down to Dontrell Inman, you live to see another down. You get in manageable field goal range. You probably don't pick up the whole 3rd and 9. But you go and take an early lead. You cash in off a turnover. Instead, you give Jacksonville some hope. And I thought at that point, throughout the whole first quarter, if you just got a lead, you would have made Jacksonville question themselves and look like they looked last night when Tennessee got that early lead.
Yeah, I mean, like when I was watching, I didn't watch the first half, I watched the second half, or I did watch the 99-yard run. But I'm sitting there going, this is never going to get close. Like, this was never going to tighten up, right? It was never, because of exactly what you said. All right, now – Kevin Bowen, 4 wins, Lakeside in Emory and Highline. Now we're on the other side of it, right? Now we got a team on fire. So give me your thoughts on this game. What has to happen?
Well, I think key number one is certainly protect Andrew Luck and get a lead for a couple of reasons. One, you don't want Watt and Clowney just pinning their ears back all game long like they did in week 4. I mean, you got behind big time in that game. You gifted them. You know, we talk so much about the tie and that decision and all of that. Remember the Ryan Kelly botch snap?
Oh, yeah.
Or the Watt strip sack in the final 2 minutes of the first half? That's 14 points you handed a winless football team. You can't do that on Sunday, especially down there, where the crowd noise is going to be ramped up a little bit. It is a much different offensive line from week 4. Quentin Nelson was your only starter in the lineup in week 4. No Ryan Kelly, different tackles this time around, and Anthony Costanzo and Braden Smith. So I think that is a big thing. And I think on the other side of the ball, you have got to have a better plan for DeAndre Hopkins. The pass defense this year has allowed a high completion percentage, but they really have not allowed a big day for an opposing wideout not named Hopkins. I think Hopkins is the only guy this year the Colts have faced that's had more than like 110 receiving yards in a game. So they've done a decent job in not letting that one guy beat you through the air. But Hopkins is that guy and did it to you back in late September. So I think it is just so, so key that you commit resources to him. When you do play those zone coverages, you don't let him run free. You know, I keep on going back to that 4th and 4 play, and Frank Reich decided to go for it. Obviously, you throw the incompletion there, terrible pass by Luck. But then you come back, and the first play that the Texans have, there's Hopkins streaking across the middle of the field for a pretty easy 25-yard catch and run, and now they're in easy field goal range to go ahead and win the game. So controlling Hopkins is an absolute must.
Man, you're preaching to the choir. How good is Deshaun Watson?
Dan, I think he's a lot better than the pure numbers indicate. I know passer rating, completion percentage, those numbers won't wow you, and he's playing behind a god-awful offensive line. But I just think his dynamic dual threat ability is so, so tough to prepare for. I mean, you can't replicate that. And I think he's a big reason why here the Houston Texans, winners of 9 straight. I mean, think back to when he was healthy last year. They were leading the AFC South before his torn ACL. This year he struggles a little bit early on in the year. They lose, you know, their first 3 games. And now here they are, you know, the hottest team in the NFL. So I think Watson is one of the tougher matchups in the NFL. Without a doubt, he's the best quarterback this defense has faced since Tom Brady in week 5. And so that would be the other big game plan issue for the Colts. I know Houston likes to run the ball a lot with Lamar Miller and Alfred Blue, but I think it's Watson and just knowing, do you spy him? Do you stay disciplined in your rush lanes? Make sure that it is 1-2 progressions, and that's it for Deshaun Watson. Don't let him ad-lib, because when he ad-libs, he's one of the more dynamic quarterbacks in the NFL.
It was interesting, Kevin. I went back and watched the game, and you made a couple points about giving 14 points. You know what was interesting? It was like, you forget also about Jadeveon Clowney dominated that game in stretches. Now, he dominated and was so hepped up that I think he had two, maybe three, you know, offsides penalties because he was going. That dude felt comfortable, Kevin, in that football game. You got to do something with that cat.
He was on something.
Woo!
That day. And a couple things stand out to me. I'm glad that you brought up the offsides penalties. That's another reason why, and, you know, maybe I shouldn't be bringing this up because it was 2 months ago, but that's why I didn't love the Frank Reich decision to take the timeout before the fourth and four in overtime. Houston's so nervous about going offsides again, and Andrew Luck's doing his cadence thing like he always does. Go ahead and snap it. Because that rush and that defense in general, I didn't think was ready for you to go ahead and snap.
They were no one gassed.
They were gassed.
Yep.
Exactly. Bill O'Brien had taken a timeout right after that third down. And then second point there, Steve Verline, who actually thought did a pretty good job on the telecast last week, he mentioned that in talking to Doug Marrone. Marrone was adamant that they wanted to attack Evan Bame, who is the center starting for Ryan Kelly. Well, what Clowney did a really nice job of back in week four, he made some interior moves that you aren't really used to him making. You know, we think of him probably as more of an edge guy. He likes to come in the interior, and Houston and Romeo Crennel moves him around. Well, Jacksonville wanted to attack Evan Bame. You know Houston is going to want to do the same thing. So knowing where Clowney is pre-snap is huge for the Colts, because instead of maybe chipping out on the edge to hit Watt as he goes across Braden Smith, the rookie at right tackle, you might need to help out in the interior as well, wherever Clowney is lining up.
Yeah, Rick Venturi talked about, Kevin, he talked about him lining up on the outside, doing a little twist to get to the A-gap, and they did that. And, I mean, he comes in scot-free. That dude is just a freak. I don't know what he does on a week-to-week basis, but when you see him up close, that dude is a freak now. I know J.J. Watt's the guy and all that, but that dude is a freak.
He is, yeah. You look up freak in the dictionary and a picture of Jadeveon. Probably the video of him making that play against the Michigan guy in the bowl game is probably the like, when he like picked up that Michigan running back and just put him right in the ground. And he had a play similar to that back in week four. I think it was maybe Jordan Wilkins on a short yardage run where the ball was snapped, and I swear Clowney lined up the fullback.
Like, I remember.
How did he get there that quickly? So, yes, Clowney and Watt, and that's why these injuries to Doyle and to Kelly, and then Hilton a little banged up and Costanzo a little banged up. Like Frank Reich says today, Anthony Costanzo doesn't practice. Kind of a rest day, but a little bit of a knee issue. Well, a little bit of a knee issue facing J.J. Watt and Jadeveon Clowney, that can turn into a little bit bigger of a knee issue. So that's just where all these pieces offensively, as you're trying to get back on track, where you commit, you know, the protection resources, how you handle the skill positions, that is a lot to juggle for the Colts here in week 14.
Yeah, and you know what? A knee issue against Watt and Clowney turns into a kidney issue for the quarterback. I mean, that's kind of way it goes, man. I mean, seriously, that's man. All right, did the Colts get too cute? I know they apparently don't think so. Did they get too cute on two things, Kevin? Did they get too cute with all the fourth down stuff? And did they get too cute with Joe Haig at tight end and all that? I thought that was what Hewitt was in there for, if you're going to block.
Yeah, they've been using LaRaven Clark a decent amount as well before Haig came back from the injured reserve list last week. I thought where they got too cute especially was the second fourth down to Eric Ebron. I like Frank Reich's aggressive nature, but I think you have to individually dissect each fourth down decision. Like, it's not just you agree with all of them or you don't agree with any of it. Like, each decision, and specifically each opponent you play, is a different grading scale in my mind. If you're facing Patrick Mahomes, go for the fourth down. It's like, you have to score touchdowns to keep up. If you're going against Cody Kessler, just score some points. Like, they scored, what, 6 last week and 9 on Thursday night. They don't score. So that's where I had a issue with the second 4th-and-1, because I was fine with pinning them back there on the Jordan Wilkins shovel pass play. But the second one, the end around to Ebron, I didn't like that play call at all, because that's the exact, or at least the handoff to Ebron, is what you did to Jacksonville back at Lucas Oil Stadium. So it's not only something you put on film, it's something you did to that exact defense. So they know full well that that's a possibility. And Jacksonville's defense is known for sideline to sideline speed. And by the time Ebron receives that handoff from Andrew Luck, the 4th and 1, 4th and inches, really, is what it was there, turned into like 4th and 4, and Ebron's going horizontally. He's not going vertically, and Miles Jack and Telvin Smith blow that play up. And that was another, like we talked earlier in the segment about Luck and the interception giving Jacksonville hope. That play then gave Jacksonville a short field. And now all of a sudden they turn that into a field goal. They're up 3-0. And they feel like they're on top of the world because they had barely led at all throughout that 7-game losing streak.
Kevin, it would be interesting, you know, those NFL films, and as soon as Ebron went in motion, you know, for the jet sweep kind of thing, how many guys are yelling, Ebron! You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Because, as you said, they had just done it. Last thing, and I'll let you go. When you look at this Colts team, all right, and we all got excited, they won some games. But when you look at this Colts team and the record gets – I mean, the schedule gets harder, right? Because all of a sudden Dallas looks pretty good. I watched the Giants. They looked a hell of a lot better beating the Bears. Where do you think they're going to end up?
So they're 6-6 now. I'd say right around 8-8, 9-7.
Yeah. 9-7 might be the high water mark, right?
Yeah, and if we were to talk this time last week, I might have said 9-7 was the baseline.
Yeah, I agree.
For this team. Yep. But that's how much things can turn in a week. And if you look at their final 4 games, it's probably right up there with all the other wild card contenders in terms of the difficulty. The good news for the Colts is Baltimore has trips to Kansas City this weekend, and then in 2 weeks they go to the Chargers. That's pretty difficult. But then they have Tampa Bay at home, and they have Cleveland at home. Whereas the Colts, like you said, the Giants are 4-8. The Giants don't have 4-8 talent. Like, they've got Saquon Barkley and Odell Beckham that can go win you a game. So that, to me, when you look at these schedules down the stretch, Tennessee and Denver have very, very easy slates to end the year. I know Tennessee suffered a couple injuries last night, but that Week 17 game, that all of a sudden could mean a whole lot for one of the teams, if not both of them, depending on what happens. But the schedule up to this point, I think the Colts have played the 3rd easiest schedule in the NFL. That's going to change here in the next 2 weeks.
Yeah, and if you'd asked me, in fact, I said it a couple weeks ago. I go, look, this is an easy schedule if you're a good team. And all of a sudden, you know, I mean, all of a sudden, here comes the Dallas Cowboys. All of a sudden, here comes,
right.
You know, I mean, I watched the Giants game.
Tennessee's gotten their act together a little bit after getting blown out here in Indy a couple weeks ago. So, yeah, I mean, for 4-8 and 7-6 Tennessee, those teams, at least right now, you feel like the Giants have more talent. And then Tennessee, that could be a almost a win-and-get-in sort of game for either or both of those teams for the season finale in Week 17.
Appreciate you, my man. Thanks for the time.
Yep, have a good weekend, Dan.
All right, you too. That's Kevin Bowen, Four Winds Lakeside in Ann Marina Hotline. Indiana men's soccer is going to face Maryland in the College Cup. How good is that? Trying to go for a 9th national title. Wow. Yeagley Jr. It's pretty damn good. Indiana takes on Louisville. It's going to be an interesting game. I think Louisville's all right. I think Assembly Hall will be rocking. But I think Indiana will win that game. I think they're a very good team. I think there are, you know, the win over Michigan State was very good. I think that they're big, they're long. I don't think they're great. I don't know that Louisville's going to, you know, press like Patino, all that kind of stuff. I'll tell you, one guy, as I morph into Indiana basketball really quick, I'm not so sure that by the end of this whole thing, El Durham's not going to be Indiana's best all-around player. Now, I'm not sure I'm right about that, but, man, the more I watch El Durham, when he shoots the basketball, I expect it to go in. Honest to goodness, I do. And when he works his brains out, he's a little Oladipo-ish in that instance. He's got good length. He's not afraid to guard. The other guy, if Langford decides to guard, you're in business, man. What do you got? John, want to talk about Romeo Langford? Odd. What do you got, John?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Dan. Hey, real quick, man. I know you're busy. With this Davis kid from Greenwood coming to play for Bloomington next year, do you think that will Langford?
I'm assuming your question was, will that make Langford stay? Not if Romeo Langford's smart. I mean, if Romeo Langford makes an emotional decision, then maybe not. But if Romeo Langford's smart and you're going to be a top 15 pick, you go to the NBA. I mean, great. Go get him. You do what I do, Trace. But I'm not staying because that guy. I mean, that guy's a good player, but he's a bit of a homesick kid. He's a bit of a, you know, he's just a kid, Jackson. So, no, look, this whole thing about, you know, he's going to stay. The only way he stays, Romeo Langford, if he gets injured or just has a crap year. But you can even have a crap year as long as you come out of high school as one of these top guys. Somebody going to draft you in the first round, and that's guaranteed green. It just is. That's guaranteed money. So, no, if Romeo Langford is smart, and I do believe they are, hell, they're smart enough to get $100,000 out of Adidas. What do you got, Greg?
So I went to the University of Dayton, and so I have a little experience watching Archie Miller basketball. I'm kind of surprised Romeo is his top recruit this year. He's got a big man next year. Doesn't his offense seem like it's really centered around a good point guard like when he had Scoochie Smith over at Dayton?
I think it's a little – I mean, if he's smart, which I think he is, he'll accommodate what he has talent-wise. I don't think he's married to any offense, and he's only been here for a third of a season, so it's really hard to say. Dayton was okay. They had the one good year. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's a little too early. And if you're going to have a really talented big guy who is a potential lottery pick, then you got to get him the ball in the situations and positions that he can do something with it. And I think as we see the season moving forward, you're going to see the same thing with Romeo Langford. I think you'll see him more involved with the ball in positions that he could do it. I mean, you know, I don't think, you know, Archie Miller was born at night, but it wasn't last night. He knows what he has, and I assume it'll continue to evolve. I mean, I don't know Scoochie Smith from Scoot Over Mr. Pips, but I'm sure he was a good player, but they were a pretty good team the one year, I know.
They just ran a lot of ball screens and whatnot with him, and I've went to the IU Northwestern game. I was kind of surprised Romeo didn't do a whole lot of that until kind of near the end.
Yeah, it's kind of odd, right? I mean, it's kind of odd. We talked about that on the show, Greg. After it, one of the things that you don't know about a guy who isn't a quote point guard is you don't know, because Romeo Langford could basically do whatever he wanted to do in high school, get the ball in the wing, drive it, pull up, get the ball, you know, wherever. You don't know how good he is off of ball screens. And I'm not talking about coming off a ball screen and shooting the ball. I'm talking about coming off a ball screen and making decisions, because, look, teams are going to trap you. Teams are going to switch to you. Teams are going to hard hedge you. Teams are going to down you, which means they try to keep it on the side. You've got to have some experience at that. And I honestly believe you're going to see more of that, as I said earlier, once the season continues and Langford gets a little more comfortable. Good call, Greg. Appreciate you very much. Yeah, I don't know his teams at Dayton. I did one game. They were in the NIT, and they didn't play well. But I know they went to the Elite Eight and were obviously very good. And I think I know the names. I don't know their players. I mean, let me just put it that way. So Scoochie Smith might have been great, but I don't know that. I don't know their team. But I know this. I do think that. I do think you will see Romeo Langford evolve into an involved offensive player once he gets, I think, a little more comfortable decision-making off a ball. Hey, look, you give him a ball screen and you let him lift up, my man's going to make some shots now. I mean, he's not afraid late either, which is why I've compared him to Jay Edwards. We'll come back. 317-239-1070 is the number. David Bell, the winningest dude like ever in high school sports. You know what I'm saying? David Bell is going to join us from Warren Central next, coming off a state title in basketball last year with the great Chris Byers, a state title in football this past year. Getting ready for another basketball season. We'll talk to David Bell at Warren Central next.
Do you have a love-hate relationship with your credit card? You love the freedom and convenience the credit card gives you, but you hate the high interest rates? And let's face it, they're high. 17, 18, even 20% APR? That's pretty outrageous. But with Lightstream's credit card consolidation loan, rather than throwing your money away on high interest payments, you can get a much lower rate, as low as 6.14% APR with AutoPay. And today, if you want an even lower rate, apply at lightstream.com/radio for a special discount. Plus, with Lightstream, your rate is fixed. So as rates continue to rise, your rates won't budge. They'll stay low. You can get a loan from $5,000 to $100,000, which means you can pay off your credit card and start paying an interest rate you can really love, thanks to Lightstream.
Ready to start saving? Apply now at lightstream.com/radio. That's right. Get your extra discount by applying today at lightstream.com/radio. That's lightstream.com/radio.
Subject to credit approval. Rate includes 0.5% auto pay discount. Terms and conditions apply and offers are subject to change without notice. Visit lightstream.com/radio for more information.
The holiday season is here and time is precious to get everything done this time of year. Putting off that haircut another week won't make mom or grandma happy. Make sure that isn't an issue by stopping into your local Great Clips today. The Indianapolis area has 87 Great Clips locations, so no matter where you're shopping, you're never too far away from squeezing in that haircut. Use the Great Clips online check-in app from your phone, tablet, or laptop and save some time. The online check-in app lets you see the estimated wait time, so you check in from wherever you are, and when you arrive at your Great Clips, you're already checked in. No more waiting around because now Great Clips will be waiting for you. It's that simple. Check the wait time, check in, head for the nearest Great Clips on your schedule, not theirs, and Great Clips is ready for you. Visit any of the 87 Great Clips salons in the greater Indianapolis area. Wherever you are in Indy, you are just 5 or 10 minutes away from a great haircut from Great Clips. And now to make it easier, download the Great Clips app where you can check in online anytime. Great Clips, it's going to be great.
Ready to check everyone off your holiday gift list in one fell swoop? Reese Nichols Jewelers makes it easy with their holiday hit list. A one-stop shop for diamonds, jewelry, and watches in absolutely every price range.
That's right, Jenny. We've compiled the season's best gift ideas all in one place. From sparkly diamonds, designer picks, new arrivals, and bestsellers, there's something for everyone on your list.
So many gifts to choose from. Top watch brands starting at just $475, up to collector's editions, designer pieces, beautiful pearls, and dazzling diamond necklaces with prices as low as $400.
And you know, sometimes the best gifts are the ones you get to choose yourself. Reese Nichols gift cards are a great option and are available in any amount and never expire. Let the Reese Nichols experts help you find the perfect gift, wrapped and ready, from our family to yours. May your holidays be merry and bright. Reese Nichols Jewelers, the ultimate gift under the tree.
Come into Lowe's for holiday deals on great gifts and lights to brighten up your home. Put hardworking tools under the tree with a Delta 10-inch compound miter saw, now just $149. Then, continue to get in the holiday spirit with 25% off select Christmas lights. All projects have a starting point. Start with Lowe's. Delta offer valid through 12/13. Selection varies by location while supplies last. Discount taken at time of purchase. See store for details.
Honey?
In here.
Oh, you painted the ceiling.
Yep.
Blue.
Feels so much less cooped up, right?
I guess. What's the yellow paint for?
Well,
the floor needs a double line, otherwise it's chaos. Can you hand me that yield sign?
It's hard to be without your bike, so do something easy and protect it with Progressive Motorcycle Insurance. With basic policies as low as $75 a year, you'll be back on the road in no time. Visit Progressive.com to quote today. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Annual premium for basic liability policy not available in all states.
Hey, it's Dan Doggett here for Whole Wall Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing. Never forget the plumbing, people. Never. Look, I use Whole Wall. I use them for my heat. I use them for my cooling. You know what? I use them, and I tell everybody that I know, and they did a survey where nearly 95% of Whole Wall customers are very satisfied with their service and would refer Whole Wall to their family and friends. That's me. 95% of people don't agree that $100,000 bars are good, but 95% agree that Whole Wall is very good, and they are very satisfied. I have no hesitation in telling you. Cold weather's here to stay. You deserve to be comfy. So Whole Wall Heating and Air Conditioning at 255 Heat. That's 255 4328. Hey, look, when I'm uncomfortable and I have a problem, I call Howald, and a truck is on the way. You got to turn to the experts, where you will find a cachet of Carrier furnaces like you've never seen before. That means when I call Howald in the future for a new heating and cooling system, main focus is going to be to make sure I am satisfied. That's what they do. Remember, at Howald Heating and Air, coming home never felt so good.
Lights the Brickyard are back. Drive the family through more than 3 million bright lights in the 2-mile course at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway this holiday season. Get your late pass now, IndianapolisMotorSpeedway.com.
Dan Dockage, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
David Bell is one of the winningest kids you're ever going to find. And we put our hands in. Warren Central High School wins basketball state championship, undefeated football state championship. David Bell, Warren Central, joins us. Now, David, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good. How about you?
I am splendid. Do you walk around with championship rings all day?
No, I tend to keep them at home.
That's pretty smart. Why? Let me go back to the basketball last year. I've known your coach for 100 years. He's a good friend of mine. All right? We're 1,000 years old between us. All right, everybody bitch, whined, and moaned about, you know, Coach Early. Why did you guys embrace Coach and go undefeated?
I think we just figured out that if we bought into him that we could have a special team. Because I remember my sophomore year, we had a pretty good team, but the whole team wasn't bought in. We went 21-3, and it was just a sour feeling in our mouth that we got put out in the first round. So I think last year that we all just decided to come together, and we just had one goal, and that was to win state.
Is it the same thing in football?
Oh, definitely. You know, we got put out last year, second in a sectional championship, so it was a lot of individuals on that team, but this team this year was just more like a brotherhood.
When you're in high school, and I, you know, one guy can make a difference at different times, but how did you go about making both a brotherhood?
I think just growing up with each other, because last year's basketball team, we all played basketball with each other throughout the years, and then the football team too, coming up in the Warren Youth League. I mean, it's just that certain vibe that you have with the players on your team that's unexplainable, to be honest.
College announcement coming up January 5th, correct?
Yes, sir.
Let's get it out of the way. Where are you going?
I'm not sure yet.
Oh, bull.
I think I'm going to IU this weekend. So.
You are?
Yes.
Your wide receiver, is that what you're going to play in college? Is it like, how does this work? Like, I see sometimes in rankings, guys, a wide receiver. Sometimes he's an athlete. Sometimes he's a quarterback. I mean, how does this work? What are you projected as a college player?
Oh, wide receiver. That's what all the coaches have been telling me so far.
All right, basketball-wise, anybody recruiting you in basketball?
No, sir.
Just they know you're playing football?
Yes. IU and Purdue said if I want to play both that I could, but –
Yeah, that's just – they're just trying to recruit you to play football there. They're just giving you a line. I used to do that at IU when I was recruiting for IU. Come on, you're playing football, right?
Yeah, just strictly football.
Is the baseball coach begging you to play baseball?
He actually is. He's been talking to me for the past few weeks, but I don't think I'm going to get out there.
Have you played baseball?
No, never.
Has the volleyball coach, women or men, asked you to play?
Nah, I don't think I'd be any good at volleyball. So.
See, I can tell the way you talk. Most athletes come on here and they're like, yeah, okay, yeah, good, yeah. You got some energy to you, brother.
Thank you.
I dig it. You're a leader. I can tell. People follow you. When you're at Warren Central, and I'm going to use football first, given the history of Warren Central football, all the great players, all the great teams, is there a sense like we got to live up to a certain standard at Warren Central?
Oh, definitely. It's either a state championship or bust every year. Coming in since I was a freshman, that was the number one goal. And, I mean, we fell short a few times. And then just November 3rd.
Who'd you lose to?
The Ben Davis Giants. Okay. And they end up winning state that year in football.
Wait. So November 3rd of the last year, not this year or the year before,
yeah.
Correct? That's what I thought.
Yeah, 2017.
So you have not lost a game in two and a half sports seasons.
That's correct.
That's pretty good. You know that?
Yeah, it is.
Like if you lose a basketball game this year, will you know how to act?
I'm going to have to swallow it tough because I'm not used to losing. So
you think?
But if it does happen, it's just a learning experience just to come back better for the next game. I'd rather lose a regular season game than to get in the playoffs and lose.
So. Oh, yeah. You don't want to lose there. Yeah. So you are announcing at the All-American game. And let me just – I don't want to ask – you know, I already kind of kiddingly did. But we're talking Big Ten, SEC, ACC, that kind of thing here?
No, just strictly Big Ten.
Big Ten? Okay. Yes. All right. Good, man. Tell Coach Byers I said, well, you're great. And we're rooting like crazy for you because, as I said, Coach, a friend of mine, long time, 100 years ago – and you're just a fun dude to watch, man. It's just it's fun to watch a kid with energy, with spirit, with heart that, you know, you can I can tell in 2 minutes that you're a leader, man. Congratulations on everything, and thanks for taking a few minutes. Now go back and study or do something. I don't know. Why are you talking to me? It's middle of school day.
Yeah, thanks for having me on your show.
That's my pleasure, man. Thank you. That's a nice kid. That's a really nice kid. That's David Bell, wide receiver extraordinaire at Warren Central, also Hooper. I mean, the dude goes undefeated. That's what he does. My son just texted me as I'm talking to you. He absolutely just went to get an MRI. And unfortunately for him, suspicions are confirmed. Torn ACL, possible meniscus tear, medial meniscus. If you're going to do it big. You know what I mean? I mean, if you're going to get hurt. So while that was coming in, that's what I got. That and I butt-dialed Kyle, not Kyle U, Kyle K, during my show. But, man, what a good dude that kid is. I'm all in on him. We're going to start being more local. You know what I'm saying? We're going to start having, if something happens locally here, I'm going to be on top. I used to do that, and I don't know where we got away from that. I mean, we're good, obviously, with the, uh-oh, wait a second. The Colts have elevated Darice Fontaine. Guess who got signed to the practice squad? Anybody want to guess that follows this? Philip Walker. Philip Walker, like, hey, Philip, we're cutting you today. Okay. When am I back? I'll probably come back around Friday. Oh, okay. I did want to talk about this. Lance Armstrong has a point about A-Rod. Like, you can say that Lance Armstrong lied, caused people's lives. There's no question about that. But Lance Armstrong was saying, hey, look, Lance Armstrong compared to A-Rod did a lot of great stuff. He says, I think there's a double standard, but I'm okay with it. Alex Rodriguez didn't raise $500 million and try to save a bunch of people's lives. That's kind of the irony of this. Look, it's great when someone hits home runs and maybe does an event here and there for the boys club. This story held a place in people's hearts and minds that was way beyond those guys. He's right. He's absolutely right. Now, the lie, we all act sanctimonious about lying. Let's be honest. I mean, let's be honest. I mean, yes, they're both PED users. A-Rod lied through his freaking teeth. Somehow A-Rod got in back in people's good graces, which I absolutely cannot understand. I'm sorry, I just can't. I can't explain why. Look, I know that. Lance Armstrong lied. His championships are tainted, but really they're not. I mean, if you really want to know the truth, everybody in that sport cheated their brains out. And I would answer this. Is the world better for Lance Armstrong winning those races and going with those Livestrong bracelets? My answer would be yes. Is the world better for A-Rod doing whatever the hell it is A-Rod does, wear a nice suit and tie, date J-Lo, and have everybody swoon over this guy? I'd answer he's just another guy. That's what I would answer. So I agree with it. I'd be curious if anybody agrees or disagrees with me on this. Like, I really believe that. Look, I don't know. They're both in their own sport. Like, you didn't have to cheat if you're A-Rod in baseball. You had to cheat if you're Lance Armstrong in cycling. Anybody that knows anything about that knows that. Like, even me, who doesn't know anything about that, knows that. You had to cheat. A-Rod didn't have to cheat. A-Rod decided that, oh, if I'm going to be on the same breath as Barry Bonds, then I got to cheat because Barry Bonds cheated. Everybody knows that. And then I'm going to lie about it. I'm going to blame it on my cousin and everything will be fine, which it ended up being fine. Honest to God. Honest to God. So there you go. I mean, Braun. What's the guy's name? Ryan Braun, the left fielder. He ruined some kid's life because he was a cheat. He's out there getting a play. I always say this. People think it's a racial thing, and it's really not. I've always said this ever since I saw Greg Doyle's article about Bob Knight's a bad guy, Gene Katie's a great guy. It's amazing to me who we decide to like. And I'm not talking about like. I'm talking about dig in deep and make the pronunciation that this guy's bad and this guy's good. The guy Mike Loxley at Maryland did 10 times the things awful that Knight did. Knight was 28 years. Loxley was like 4. And he did more things awful, abuse, than Knight did in his 28 years. But Loxley is, oh, man, we love him. Katie did the same things as Knight. And we laugh at him. We do. We laugh at him. And the truth of the matter is, they're the same guy. It's the same guy, but it's just a matter. Like, hey, if you know anything about, you had to cheat in cycling. Did you have to lie about it? Yeah, actually. Did you have to make a choice at some point? Like, hey, you know what? If I get caught here, then guess what? We're going to lose a lot of money for a lot of people. I'm not making excuses for them. I'm giving you the reality. Anytime you don't just say, hey, all right. You know, all right, I agree with you. Then you get ripped. Hey, real quick, Kevin, how are you?
How are you, sir?
Good.
Hey, Coach, I just wanted to thank you and your wonderful show for bringing what a lot of people complain and bitch about. But I don't know if you watched the awards banquet with Tyler Trent last night, and I thought it was phenomenal.
Yeah, I did, and I'm just. I started crying, if you want to know the truth. I mean, I'm not going to lie. I started crying watching him, and I tweeted out his – I read the article in the Star, and cut and pasted a part of it. And truth of the matter is, I sent it to my wife. I was crying. She came up down from downstairs. She goes, I'm bawling here. I sent it to my family just as a reminder over Christmas that, hey, look, man, you know, what Tyler Trent is doing is incredible. I pray that God says, you know what? We're going to give you more time here. I pray that, and I don't know if that's going to happen, but I pray that.
I just wanted to thank you again, and I actually taped it. My kids weren't home from school. When they got home, that's the first thing I had them watch, and I really appreciate it.
Check out the article in the Star that he wrote. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable.
Yes, sir.
Gut-wrenching. You're welcome. Gut-wrenchingly unbelievable. All right, we'll come back. We're closing out the week. I'll recap the bets that Doug Kazarian gave us and give you one of mine when we come back.
At Huntington, we're always looking out for you. So when our customers told us it can be tough to keep track of spending, we invented the Huntington Hologram.
Honey, what is that?
It's a hologram of a banker. Lets us know if our savings are on track and keeps us updated 24/7. Cool, right?
Update. You are under budget for restaurants.
Yeah, that is cool, but... Do you have to bring it to dinner?
Well, yeah. It keeps us updated 24/7, so I mean, it has to come.
Update. You are under budget for restaurants.
Don't worry about it. You'll get used to it.
Update. You are under budget for restaurants.
Well, eventually you'll get used to it.
No.
So we simplified. Presenting Huntington Heads Up. You set the monthly amounts you want to spend on restaurants, and we'll send a heads up to your phone to keep you on track. It's just one more way we're looking out for you. Huntington, welcome. Member FDIC, carrier's message and data rates may apply.
One of the great things in life is intimacy. It's a key part of how we express ourselves and share with the person we love. Physical, emotional, and spiritual intimacy. As much as we want to share that intimacy, there are times it just doesn't seem to work out. 40% of the time in men over 40, it just doesn't work. Many couples go months and sometimes years without addressing erectile dysfunction or other sexual issues in what can easily be resolved with just one visit to the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Our Indiana licensed providers use FDA-approved medications to get intimacy back into your relationship in just one visit. There is no need to wait any longer. We are here for you, both of you. Call 999-9000 to set up a private consultation. 999-9000.
The clinic visit, evaluation, and testing of the medication is just $99.
EndyMensClinic.com for more information. 999-9000.
Hey, I'm Jeff Saturday for More Restoration, a true leader in the restoration industry. More Restoration is currently expanding their team and looking for experienced project managers, carpenters, drywallers, painters, and restoration technicians. And More is offering a $1,000 signing bonus. More Restoration's commercial services includes healthcare, industrial facilities, churches, schools, and more. If you want to be on a winning team and you want more out of your career, you should call More or go to More Restoration at 3610 Shelby Street. Tell them Jeff Saturday sent you.
Hey, Dad, I wanted to remind you that the holidays are close, real close, and Mom and I don't need wool socks again. At Helzberg, you can get jewelry for Mom and get a free Nintendo Switch system for me. Two gifts in one trip. I'm not saying you're a last-minute shopper, but I'm not saying that either.
Get gifts that get gifts at Helzberg Diamonds, like a free Nintendo Switch system when you spend $1,199 or more. Helzberg Diamonds, a Berkshire Hathaway company. Limited time offer while supplies last. See online or in-store for details. Games sold separately.
On cold, snowy days, you just want to stay in the comfort of your home until your furnace breaks. Hi, I'm Corey Kreitzberger, General Manager at One Hour Heating and Air Conditioning. For same-day repairs that will keep you warm and cozy, trust the highly trained technicians at One Hour. Call 855-1-HOUR today and get $51 off any repair. That's 855-1-HOUR.
Your comfort is just a call away. Call 1-HOUR.
Terms and conditions may apply. License 800-1-0668.
Hey, Dan Doggett here for my friends at Hubler Chevrolet. Listen up, because Hubler is changing the way you buy a vehicle. Introducing the 10-year, 200,000-mile warranty, limited warranty. It's unbelievable on all Chevys. This is only offered at Hubler's five Chevy dealerships. Other dealers cannot do this. Real simple. Click drivehublerchevy.com. Shop Indiana's largest inventory of Chevy. Find the perfect one at discounted price. 10 years, 200,000-mile limited warranty for free. December deals, 18 Silverado, $179 a month. Hubler has the largest selection, 18 Cruze, $159 a month. New Trax, $149 a month. Hubler is Indiana's Chevy giant, new home of the 10-year, 200,000-mile limited warranty. Visit any of Hubler's five Chevy locations. A quick click, drivehublerchevy.com. Year-end savings end January numero uno, 888-221-5101, or to score a VIP appointment or click drivehublerchevy.com.
Looking for the perfect holiday gift? Get him a shirt from Untuckit, the original Untucked shirt. For all your holiday shopping, use promo code TRAFFIC for 20% savings at Untuckit.com or 50 Untuckit stores.
The Pacers head to Orlando to take on the Magic this evening at 6:30 on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan. Dan Dockage, weekdays noon till 3 on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan.
December 7th, the day that will live in infamy. Thank you to all of our veterans. Thank you to all of our servicemen, including our EMTs, including our police officers. Everybody out there, it is an incredibly thankless job, and I thank you. And to all of the people, and I know most are passed away now, man, the people of Pearl Harbor. Holy cow, if you ever have a chance and you really want to see something where it's like, oh man, the USS Arizona on Pearl Harbor, it's still leaking oil. It literally is still leaking oil. Yes. That's how much, you know, now you can see it leaking oil. It is incredible. It really is. It's amazing. What's going on there, but it is leaking oil. So, and also, I tell you what, you know, when you go to the USS Arizona, it's like, man, hey, how about just shutting up and having a little respect? I mean, so many people don't understand that. It's a memorial. Have a little respect. It's amazing. Anyway, but no, I mean, it's good. It's good. Earlier today, at the end of this show, we might as well give them out. Today, I disagree with Doug Kazarian's take the under. Doug is ESPN's gambling expert. Navy, Army, he said take the under. It's 40. I would take Army minus 6.5. But I'm not touching either. Broncos minus 3.5. I absolutely love. Seahawks minus 3. I absolutely 1,000,000% love. I don't like it. I love it. Like, I love the Seahawks minus three. And you know what else? You know what else it does for you if you take the Seahawks? I mean, let's be honest. Monday night football games aren't great. They're not great. But it's a Monday night football game. And the Vikings are going to choke, just like the Cowboys eventually are choked. So, I'm not giving you a lock. I'm just giving you what Doug has. I will give you a lock. Are you asking for a lock? I'll give you a lock if you're asking for a lock, and it's going to involve a local team. College basketball this weekend is interesting. I think probably I'm going down to do Xavier and at Cincinnati. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Couple games I would give you. I'd give you Providence. Give the 9 to Massachusetts. That's at Providence. I would kind of take that all day. I really would. That's tonight. You can, I think, watch that somewhere tonight. And then the other game tonight, I think I'm taking Indiana and I'm giving Louisville the points. Yeah, I don't have the line here. I assume the line's somewhere between 4 and 6, but I'll take that. Tom, what do you got? Katie Knight.
Hey, Dan, real quick, I just want to push back on what you said about Katie and Knight. I'm not a Purdue fan. I'm an IU fan, and I was a Bob Knight fan for a while until he got a little crazy. And you know more about the IU situation than I'll ever imagine. But what you said about them being, I'm paraphrasing here, they're the same guy, did the same things. From the outside looking in, I mean, Katie didn't have mass defections like Knight did from his program. And it just appears to me that the lack of Knight's ability to treat anybody that he didn't love with anything less than disdain just, I didn't see that from Katie. Am I missing something?
Yes and no. Yes. You're missing something in that they treated their teams the same. I mean, I'm sorry. I mean, people act like every day we went to practice we were going to get beat up, or every day we were going to go to practice and, you know, coach was going to kill you. No, I mean, they treated their teams exactly the same. Coach Katie's come on here and he said, hey, look, we stopped in practice at 4 a.m. You know, coaches just did that. All right. But in terms of externally, Gene Katy was far better externally, and there was a big switch made. I'm not sure what year it was, probably 92, 93, where a coach used to start smiling on the sidelines more because they told him, look, you look nasty, you look snarling. So he made a change. Knight wasn't capable of making a change, but in terms of how they treat But you ask me a question, I'll give you an answer. But the same thing, they did the same things at their teams.
Yeah. Hey, and one other thing real quick, Dan. Tyler Trent's story. I hope people aren't missing his primary story. I'm not putting words in his mouth, but every time I hear him speak, this whole thing is about him sharing the truth of everyone he talks to, that he's okay because in eternity he's going to be with his Savior. And that's his whole point. That's what he's saying, and I think it really matters. So we need to be listening to him, okay?
Yeah, I appreciate you. Thanks for the phone call. Really good stuff. Yeah, I mean, look, a lot of it's perception. Like, ESPN had a camera set on Coach Knight. You put a camera on anybody that isn't, like, a modern coach, you know. I mean, modern coaches hide their mouths like Krzyzewski does, or they know they're on TV, so don't do it because everything's about recruiting. I just didn't care. I'm sorry, Knight did not care. He did not care. If a recruit was going to come to Indiana, then he was going to come to a game, and if Knight needed to rip ass, he was going to rip ass. I'm sorry, he just was. And whether people liked that or not, that was on them. Now, is that you couldn't do that now? Oh, you couldn't do that. Like, I think, it's, you know, Shaka Smart was a great coach, and I'd hire Shaka anytime, anywhere, but he's at Texas now, and he's got to be a little careful because he's trying to recruit 5-star kids. When he was at the other place, VCU, it wasn't like that. He didn't have to recruit 5-star kids. He was recruiting kids with an edge, but now it's different. It just is. I'm sorry. So, you know, now, do you have to be that way? No. People say, well, you don't have to coach like that. I'm not saying you do. I'm saying that's the way he did it, and that's the way it was comfortable for him. And anybody that thinks he was like, hey, all you got to do is talk to former Duke players about Coach K before he, you know, found Hosanna and all that stuff and decided, hey, I'm going to recruit, you know, all that. I mean, all you got to do is, you know, talk to guys that were there in the 80s and 90s. I mean, you know, just telling you. I mean, that's, I'm sorry. You may not like that. You may not like that I'm saying that, but it's the truth. What are you going to do? So, anyway, I hope everybody has a great weekend. Take Indiana and the points, or give the points, because I think they're going to beat, I think you're going to win a double-digit game. I think Assembly Hall is going to be rocking. I think you're going to see not the rout that they did against Marquette, but I think you're going to see kind of an all-day 6-12 and however it ends up win. I do. I think that's kind of what you're going to see. I think Indiana's good. And I think Indiana just won two really tough games. And I think when you win two really tough games, you know, things seem to go well for you over the next few games. I mean, the season is long, so to say, well, you know, they won two games are great. No, or they lost two games and they're horrible. No. Like, I don't think Nebraska's horrible. Or, I don't think Northwestern's horrible. I just think, man, you go to Assembly Hall, you're going to get beat most times. And you play a Michigan team, you play number 5 team in the country, you're going to get beat most times. So I'm looking forward to the weekend. Hey, if you're not doing anything, I know Indiana plays basically the same time, but I've got Xavier and Cincinnati at 2:30. I think it's ESPN or ESPN2. I can't remember which one. Join us. Have a great, great weekend, everybody. John is next. Pacers tonight.
Monday mornings have never been better on The Fan.
I love it. I love it.
Each Monday after the Colts game, join Colts legend Jeff Saturday as he takes you inside the Colt Tunnel.
Making a full all-in on the offensive line.
It's Saturday on Monday mornings from 7 to 10. Every Monday after a Colts game.
You're watching Andrew get better at it every week.
It's Jeff Saturday with Kevin Bowen and Jeff Rickard.
It's just fun to watch.
Only on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan. The Ride with JMV.
And I know that everybody's supposed to be happy. I mean, what did I pick them start of the season? 7-9. Oh, well, hold on a minute. They are who we thought they were. And that might be the case, but they were in position. Certainly, you're going to have to win out. And win out starts coming up on Sunday in Houston. But I was completely disappointed.
The Ride with JMV. Weekdays from 3 till 6 on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Hey guys, good news. The outrageously expensive little blue pill is now generic, which means you can get the prescription medication to treat ED at affordable prices. And Hims makes it extra affordable. Right now, get your first month's supply for free. All you pay is just $5 for your medical consultation when you go to forhims.com/perform. After that, it's just $30 for a month's supply. Sure beats paying big bucks for just one blue pill, doesn't it? Plus, you won't need an awkward in-person doctor's appointment to get the prescription. Hims has doctors online who can prescribe the medication, and a pharmacy sends it right to your door. It's affordable, private, and incredibly easy. Nobody likes dealing with ED. Now, thanks to Hims, nobody has to. And that's really good news. To get your first order for just $5, you need to go to this exclusive address, forhims.com/perform. That's forhims.com/perform for your first month for just $5. forhims.com/perform.
They've sold over 25 million albums worldwide.
Oh, we wanna be with you.
Now, Hootie and the Blowfish return for their group therapy tour. Saturday, August 17th, Ruoff Home Mortgage Music Center, Hootie and the Blowfish, with special guest Bare Naked Ladies.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me.
Tickets on sale now at LiveNation.com. All the hits with Hootie and the Blowfish, part of the Coors Light Concert Series.
Best service, best products. Do it best.
Hi, this is Jeff Cardwell of Cardwell Home Center on Madison Avenue with my wife, Cheryl.
When shopping for your house and yard, we've got what you need.
A rental center, a garden center, and thousands of home improvement items in stock.
Plus an extensive Pratt & Lambert paint selection.
And like all locally owned Do It Best stores, money spent at Cardwell Home Center stays in our community.
Your neighborhood Do It Best is stocked with items to fill his toolbox with great gifts like your choice Stanley Tools, Wonder Bar, 50-pack utility knife blades, utility knife, tape measure, or rip hammer, only $4.97 each, or a Black & Decker 29-piece screwdriver bit set, only $7.97. Projects are endless with a Dremel rotary toolkit, only $69.97.
Shop local. Shop Do It Best.
Stop by and see us at Cardwell Home Center on Indy South Side, located at 3205 Madison Avenue, just south of Madison Avenue and the East Street Split.
Best service, best products. Do it best.
Hey, this time of year, you're spending a lot of money using that card all the time. It's JMV for Farm Credit Union. How can you save this time of year? Well, get with Farm Credit Union and my friend Trevor Green. Smart ways to help pay for those extra holiday spending needs. Always genius, always original. It's Farm Credit Union. Ask for Trevor Green. Slide by a branch location today. Or for more information, it is incredibly easy. Online, forumcu.com to ask for a personal loan option today.
Kevin Bowen delivers the latest news on the Colts and Pacers with Grady and Big Joe, Dan Dockich, and JMV. Listen every week to Kevin's Corner, brought to you by Great Clips. It's gonna be great.
Well, that was ugly.
Jaguar 6, the Colts
nothing.
All right, time to shake it off and start a new winning streak.
And it is caught! Touchdown!
Join us this Sunday as the Colts head to Houston for a showdown with the division-leading Texans. Coverage starts at 10. Matt Taylor and Jim Sorgi have the play-by-play at 1. Only on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan. Your exclusive home for the Indianapolis Colts.
The season is still early.
The Pacers are finding their way in the East.
Ahead to Turner, he'll take it in.
And you can hear every play of every game on FM 107.5 at 1070 The Fan.
Oladipo.
Next up for the Blue and Gold, the Pacers head to Orlando to take on the Magic. Tonight at 6:30, Mark Boyle has the call.
6 seconds to go. Three ball.
On FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan, your home for Pacers basketball. This is Indy Sports Center.
WFNI, WIBC, HD2.
W298 BB, W228 CX, Indianapolis.
Soccer Saturday featuring Indy 11. If this is your football, this is your show. Saturday at 9 on The Fan.
What in the hell do you think you're doing?
Hey, John Boy.
I'm telling you straight, it's my way or the highway. So anybody wants to walk, do it now.
Hey, everybody, we're all gonna get laid.
Kick is up, and it is long enough, and it is good! Adam Vinatieri, at age 45, drills one from 57 yards out.
It was kept alive by Oldis Depot, and Sabonis with a left hand.
John, I have never been better to be on the air with you here in Indianapolis, a place where so many of my dreams have come true.
The Ride with JMV, FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan.
Let me give you the old good afternoon. We're live in Broad Ripple today, right in the heart of one of our favorite places, of course, the old pros table, Bud Light Blue Friday, and we have Cowboys Colts tickets to give away. And we are in, we're kind of in a hurry today, too, because we're tightened up. So you got the Pacers in Orlando later on tonight. You got Colts Happy Hour. So we're tightened up a little bit. Normal show, I'm going to go till 5:30, then host Colts Happy Hour from 5:30 until 6:30. And then we're on to the Pacers and the Orlando Magic down in Orlando. So we are going to be crunched a little bit compared to normal for time. So you may want to get out here, get set, get your name here, and maybe get some tickets to that Cowboys-Colts game coming up next weekend here. First things first, we got a lot to discuss. The Colts did, and this is the first time, if you remember, there was not too much conversation, but a little bit of conversation about Reese Fountain, the wide receiver, the rookie out of Northern Iowa. He thought he was ready. Clearly, they didn't think he was ready. And because of injury situations, and certainly another lengthy list of them, including Dontrell Inman, who has already been ruled out for Sunday down in Houston, Reese Fountain has been elevated to the
53-man roster. We saw that within the last 35 minutes or so. And again, Mo Alie-Cox on that list of injuries. Ryan Kelly on that list of injuries in a game that you need to win. I mean, rest of the way out, if you really want to sniff and you get a little bit of help, but you really want to sniff a playoff situation, seriously, I mean, you got to win the rest of the way out. That starts down in Houston. Texans winners of 9 consecutive. That is coming up on Sunday, and I get you started along with Big Joe Stasniak at 10 a.m. as we get going with the Colts pregame huddle here on FM 107.5 and 1070 The Fan. I was trying to think, how in the world am I going to put into words last night, and I'm kind of against the grain on this, all right? I'm kind of against the grain because I know some have said that last night, you know, you really can't compare it to a home date for the Jags and, you know, the goose egg that their defense put on the board for the Colts. But I'm sorry. You remember how I got in here and I was incredibly butthurt on Monday? Like Monday, I step in and it was disappointing. You lose 6-0. And I thought that there were so many ways that simply did not have to happen. So many ways where you could have stretched that win streak to 6 consecutive and then really made things interesting for that last wild card situation, right? I mean, more interesting than I guess they are now, where you got to win out, you got to hope for a great deal of help, and then you get that Thursday nighter. You get that Thursday nighter within the AFC South and Jacksonville and their clown show. And, hey, listen, you go back to Sunday, and Jacksonville tried their hardest. Every time they did something right, it seemed like they did something wrong, right? It was like the one step forward, two steps back. The problem with that on Sunday is the Colts could do nothing right. I mean, nothing offensively right, could not execute at all. Fourth down calls where you wonder, you know, you're going for it instead of trying to pile some points on the board against just the incredibly awful Cody Kessler. So there are a couple of different ways you can look at this. I mean, you can look at it as if, hey, that was at home, and you saw, like, Tom Coughlin was up in the upper deck, you saw on Sunday, and he was, like, his number two pencil, and he would, like, take notes about who's dogging it, who's not, right? He's taking notes, and he's pumping his fist there at the end. Hey, that's great. And then you get that piece of crap last night. I mean, you talk about making Colts fans feel horrifically awful about a loss. And that's kind of how I felt on Monday after the loss itself. I mean, and I look at it from a couple of different angles. You know, I look at it from the coaching standpoint of, hey, you kind of know the game in which you're coaching. Know that it feels as if going back to that second half of the first meeting with Jacksonville, the points were going to be at a premium, so maybe play it accordingly, right? And then there's another part of me that says, all right, we talked about this offense, and, hey, Andrew Luck is back, and the offensive line, and putting up numbers, and the tight ends, and, yeah, all right, and you can't even get in the end zone once? I mean, even when, again, they did defensively play well, but there was such a lack of execution, and it was so disappointing. That's how I felt on Monday, starting the show at 3, and that's how I felt last night watching that clown show in Nashville. That's the team. That is the team that blanked the Colts. I mean, the team that just, they were giving up all over the field. And all due respect here to the 99-yard run, the longest, it ties the longest run in history. Prior to that, you go back to 83 on Monday Night Football, and I actually remember watching that, where Tony Dorsett of the Dallas Cowboys did it. Be that as it may, Derrick Henry ties the longest run in the history of the NFL. And if you watch that play, I mean, there are dudes giving up. A.J. Boye, for example, got clowned a couple of different times, right? I think he got stiff-armed twice. But I'm going to give him credit because he got stiff-armed, got back up, and still tried to track down Henry. Did you see all those guys at the line of scrimmage who were just kind of tied up and said, whatever. Smith, the linebacker, just kind of jogging. Those guys expected Boye to tackle him, and he didn't. These guys are all jogging. I thought about it last night. As great as that run was, it looked like, to me, that he was running against or playing against a junior high team. I mean, that was some Pop Warner stuff right there. It was embarrassing.
That was so par for the course of Jacksonville, and I'm sorry. I know that it looked different on Sunday, but that was still the same bunch, the same level of dysfunction, the same who gives a crap, look what we didn't do this year, let's go ahead and pack it in. That was the same team that put the Colts in this situation and snapped a five-game win streak. Oh, yeah, by the way, and blank them. Goose egg, no score. That's that same team last night that it I don't even know how to put it. It was awful. It was like literally that run was like Tecmo Bo Jackson in Tecmo Bowl. I mean, Bo Jackson, I mean, you could run, if you remember that video game back in the early 90s, Super Tecmo Bo, you could run him everywhere. I mean, it was, you even had to make it, he was so good, you had to make it interesting to even try to get somebody to tackle you. So, I mean, evidently, look it up on YouTube one of these days, the video where it lasts about 2 minutes and some dude is just taping himself running Super Tecmo Bowl Bo Jackson around the field. I mean, just doing circles and loops and going back and going forward. That's what that looked like last night. I mean, he's stiff-arming. I'll give Boye credit. At least he got back up, right? I mean, he didn't, like, get tied up at the line of scrimmage and just stand there, did he? Or if he's Jalen Ramsey, you run your mouth forever and you're not fast enough to try to get into play at all? And I can say this, and I look, a need category, there's no doubt. Is the dude talented? There is no doubt. Is there anybody out there, would you really like to have this dude on your team? Would you like to have that guy there? I mean, when you play that position, one of the things you have to have is a great deal of short memory, right? I mean, you have to have a high level of confidence and absolutely no recollection. If something happens, then you're still the greatest thing. And there's no problem there. I mean, you can be really good. He's incredibly talented, but he has just helped screw that team over. And as good as he looked, and he did, against the Colts last weekend, he has been a clown the entire year. I don't even know. Somebody was asking me this earlier today. Hey, would you, because I think the guy signed up in Jacksonville until 2020. Would you want that guy on your team? I don't want that guy on my team. I wouldn't want him on my team. I mean, hell, we can make fun of A.J. Bouye for, you know, what happened to him, getting stiff-armed, but at least he got back up and ran and tried to do something. That was absolutely embarrassing for one of the greatest all-time single plays, right, from scrimmage, 99-yard run. That was more about the lack of giving a crap than it was anything else. And I'm trying not to take anything away from Derrick Henry, but that's how it was. I mean, that had everything but the Benny Hill music in the background of it. Yakety sacks. That's what it needed. And he looked like Super Tecmo Bo Jackson, just running all over the stiff arm in here, and I'm not going. And it looked like that they expected him to go out of bounds and kind of dog it, and he didn't. I mean, hell, nobody really challenged him except for Bouye. And then if you could see in that play running behind, you can see Smith, the linebacker, is like just jogging, lightly jogging, because he thinks somebody else is going to get him. And then he kind of, you know how when you figure out, watch baseball guys do this, right? All of a sudden you figure out that, hey, it's not going to be a home run, and you're into your home run trot, right, before you get to first base. And you have the oh, crap moment where you better start running. That's kind of what he did last night. You know, the rest of the guys were all kind of locked up. That was what was amazing to me, is that there were so few people actually in the picture. I mean, where the hell was everybody else? Everybody else is kind of dancing around on the line of scrimmage, and that is the level of amazing dysfunction that blanked the Colts last weekend. And listen, different team, different day, a home game, whatever, that can't sit well still with anybody. I mean, that's what is going to tear this season, the second half of the season down. That going to burst the bubble? Because really, I thought they were going to lose one more. I honestly did. I just didn't think it was going to be that game. And I sure as hell didn't think it was going to be that game with that situation. But that was something that you rarely, if ever, I mean, hell, if you've only seen it once, right? And that happened in 1983. But it was more kind of
a clown show than it was anything else. And the Tennessee Titans took full advantage of a team that simply, you could tell, especially after that first hit, they didn't want to be there for nothing. It was over. And I go from wondering if Tom Coughlin is going to be the guy and who is he going to get rid of and who is he going to fire, to wondering if, all right, so you put together this mess, maybe you should go. I mean, this is the mess that you all put together, you and David Caldwell. So it's incredibly embarrassing last night. But a couple of thoughts on that, and you equate that with what took place in Jacksonville on Sunday, and you have yourself a first cold segment right there. 239-1070 is the email address, jmv@1070thefan.com. If you want to go there via email, calls today, predictions today about the Texans. They have said often that was that game in September that gave them the kickstart. But let's face it, they have just become more healthy. They had guys that were dinged up coming back from injuries like Watt, like Watson, and then all of a sudden now these guys are feeling it. I mean, look at Carson Wentz, for example. Carson Wentz is still trying to find it, right? Because, what, he was hurt toward the end of the season a year ago? I mean, he still is trying to find it. You've seen a guy like Deshaun Watson start to find it, but it took more than a bit of a month there, right? J.J. Watt, the same. I mean, in the running, certainly a part of the conversation for comeback player of the year in the NFL, without a doubt. Clowney has been good. Their defense has been good. And as I've told you in the past, DeAndre Hopkins is absolutely the best wide receiver in the NFL. And we had this conversation on Wednesday with John McClain of the Houston Chronicle. Here's why he's the best receiver in the NFL to me. He may not be the fastest, and he sure as hell may have crapped up the hotel room at the Crown Royal Plaza when he was back during the combine years ago. Maybe all that took place. But as a wide receiver, you throw that in the vicinity of DeAndre Hopkins and he catches it. I mean, it does not have to be right on the money or right on the dime, as we talk about. Does not have to necessarily be in that tight window. He opens the window. He makes the window larger. That's what stands out to me, and that's probably my chief concern going into Sunday. Because what did he do in that first meeting in September? My man ran wild. I will tell you this. A lot of you that were very pro-Frank going for it in overtime on fourth down as he did, you probably thought, hey, if they punt it away, Hopkins is so good and nobody was going to be able to cover him that he probably would have made up that ground that they would have gained have punting it away and put themselves in field goal position anyway. That has been a part of the dynamic, a part of the discussion, the debate you had on that particular call. And you might be right. I mean, you might be right. I mean, what did it take him? Like one catch to get down the field? But you throw that anywhere near him and he catches it. And that's what stands out to me. And you look at that defense, and the defense was hardly the problem, hardly the issue this past week. But dealing with him is tough to understand how that's going to be done and how they're going to be able to do it. Certainly not single, even with multiple. Who else do they have to beat you? Demaryius Thomas hasn't been that great since the trade deadline acquisition because Will Fuller was done for the season at wide receiver. Their running game has been pretty good. The offensive line is still not, but the defense is. The quarterback is a playmaker, and they, to me, have the best wide receiver in the NFL going right now, which is going to be a tall task. And they've won 9 consecutive. As we talked about earlier this week, they have people down in Texas believing. Now, we were debating whether or not it was the first legitimately real time, and actually John McClain said it wasn't, but